This is a production of SDPB.
Touchdown! This is for a state championship. Oh, direct kick and it's good!
There's going to be some highlights coming off of this.
The short range jumper.
Edging out in lane four, the top seed.
This South Dakota High School State Championship event is conducted under the direction of the South Dakota High School Activities Association.
And we've made it to Championship Saturday night in Aberdeen, the Barnett Center on the campus of Northern State University. I'm Brad DeBeer alongside Steve Erickson for Class B boys basketball action here tonight. It's been a fantastic first 10 games of this 2024 tournament. And now we are ready for our final two games. Steve, third and fourth place matchup with White River and Castlewood, followed by DeSmet and Howard for a state title. What a great first two and a half days.
It's been great. Great tournament. We thought that coming in, and it's proved to be the point. Two teams playing this first game that obviously had aspirations of playing a little bit later in the evening. So we'll see how they bounce back tonight, but I'm expecting a good one in this first one.
You know, White River was the one that really looked dejected the most coming off the floor right away. And then Castlewood, a couple guys that really took it hard. Afterwards, I saw a couple of fellas out in the locker room, or in the locker room area or the hallway. And like you said, they had aspirations. But how do you bounce back? You don't want your high school career for the seniors to end on a sour note. You don't come out and play hard, and you don't have a chance to let up with these two teams.
Absolutely. And two veteran coaches that have been through it, that they're going to have their guys ready to go. So.
Earlier today, Viberg Hurley defeated Leola Frederick 84-75 for seventh place. And then our Constellation Championship game went to Wessington Springs. The Spartans over the Gorillas of Gregory 55-51. As we get ready for our third place game, as we said, White River and Castlewood. The number one seed taking on the number three seed. And then for the state title a little bit later on, Howard and DeSmet. We thought it was electric in here last night. Get ready, because this place is going to about get ready to blow the roof off it as these things get going here tonight. Let's take a look at our profiles. Check on this Castlewood team, the Warriors. Paul Roush, the head coach out of Hamlin County. 67 students in grades 9 through 12 there in Castlewood. Royal, blue, and gold. Minnesota Rouser, the school song. How'd they get here? Well, they won a couple of region games over Old Amber, Mona, Rutland, and Woolsey Westington, then beat Centerville in the SODAC 16, rather handily. A win over Leola Frederick on the opening day, 72-67, and the heartbreak loss last night to DeSmet, 40-37 in a defensive battle. Take a look at the starting five for the Warriors. Lane Tweet, the 6-foot senior. Quincy Thu, a 6-foot senior. And then three juniors, Luke Baumberger, 6'4". Jamison Kessler, 6-foot. And the big fella, 6'9", Brian Lowy. And he's been really good throughout this entire state tournament.
Yeah, Castlewood, experienced team. They've been here for a couple years in a row now. Veteran coach and Paul Roush. They'll be ready to go tonight and looking for these guys to get up and down the floor and show us what they're made of.
And on the other side, Eldon Marshall's only been here like 19 straight times, so I guess they'll be ready to play too. You look at the Tigers out of Millett County. Eldon Marshall, again, as we said, the head coach, 86 is their enrollment, purple and gold. On Wisconsin is the school song. Well, they took care of Ulrichs in the opening round, beat Jones County. Highmore Herald in SODAC 16 action, and then the win over Viberg Hurley by 15 to open up the tournament, and that 6-point loss to a scrappy, just no-go-away type team in Howard last night. They'll start this way. Nicholas Marshall, the All-State guard, 6'1 senior. Mackenzie Wyke, a 5'8 junior. Ray Crow, a 5'8 senior. Eva Steen Wright, a 6'6" senior. And a guy that, boy, has played really well also to go along with Marshall. It's Jordan Euler, 6'6 senior at the other post position. So fun to watch. He's not true post. He's more of a swing man, but boy, he can get to the basket quick.
Yeah, veteran team, veteran people around. Again, been here 19 years in a row. They're ready to roll.
We get ready to wind it down. Buzzer will sound, and we'll turn it over to Aiden McCafferty for our starting lineups and our national anthem announcements.
Good evening. The South Dakota High School Activities Association, along with its corporate partners, Sanford Health, Dakota Bank, Farmers Union Insurance, Billion Automotive, AgTegra Cooperative, ABC Rentals, Furniture Mart, South Dakota Highway Patrol, Lake Area Tech, Masaba, Experience Sioux Falls, and the South Dakota Army National Guard welcomes you to this final session of the State Boys High School Basketball Tournament. This tournament is being conducted under the guidance and regulation of the South Dakota High School Activities Association for the enjoyment and benefit of high school student athletes. Good sportsmanship is essential for the success of these programs. We hope you will enjoy the games and support your athletes in a positive and sportsmanlike manner. Ladies and gentlemen, please stay standing as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem. Singing our national anthem is Grace and Sophia Overland of Mobridge Pollock, under the direction of Lisa Son. We would remind all in attendance that the proper respect is to remove your hat, face the flag, stand at attention with your right hand over your heart. Veterans and active duty military not in uniform may salute the flag. Ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets had glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Let's take a look at our starting lineups in alternating fashion. First, for the visiting Castlewood Warriors, 6 foot senior number two, Lane Tweet. For the Tigers, 6'1" senior number one, Nicholas Marshall. For the Warriors, 6 foot senior number three, Quincy Thu. And for the Tigers, 5'8" junior number three, Mackenzie Wyke. For the Warriors, 6'4" junior number 20, Luke Bomberger. For the Tigers, 5'8" senior number five, Ray Crow. For the Warriors, 6 foot junior number 22, Jamison Kessler. For the Tigers, 6'6" senior number 10, Evastine Wright. And for the Warriors, 6'9" junior number 33, Brian Lowy. For the Tigers, 6'6" senior number 23, Jordan Euler. The Warriors are coached by Jeff Sickink, head coach Paul Rausch. The Tigers are coached by John Petrick, Justin Morrison, head coach Eldon Marshall. Officials for this game, Josh Kemp, Chris Frericks, Jim Fugate. Alternate official, Jordan Odins.
And we are ready for action here in our third and fourth place matchup. The Castlewood Warriors, the White River Tigers, and fun last night, Steve. We got to hang out with the officials a little bit, just visit and chat about everything. And just watching them interact with each other and, you know, complimentary to the three guys that will get the championship game tonight. It's a big deal for these guys as well as we talk about it.
Yeah, that's a, you know, it's a brotherhood just like the coaching fraternity, and fun to see those guys.
You know, usually we're yelling at them. We get to actually talk to them. They actually listened to me last night. It was weird. Lowy will win the tip. Thu will control, and Tweet will bring it across the timeline. Weick, Mackenzie Weick, will guard Lane Tweet. Thu, backdoor cut. Blocked is Tweet. Euler out of nowhere to block that. Ray Crow
great
guarded by
door,
Tweet. Yep. Last touch by Tweet out of bounds.
Great backdoor cut and pass. And Euler, like he's been all tournament, just making some plays.
Well, I think he's showing the state how athletic he is. If you didn't know him before this weekend, you should by now, because, wow, he is fun to watch. And 6 foot 6 inch senior. Nick Marshall, give it to Crow. Right wing three on the way, too strong. Last touch, no touch. Air ball will go Castlewood basketball. Brian Lowy tried to reach out and grab it and got away from him. He never touched it. Jamison Kessler will bring it across the timeline for Castlewood. Backdoor cut this time. Kessler up and in. They switch roles, and Kessler lays it off the glass.
Great pass from Tweet. Almost identical play.
Mackenzie Weick at the other end with the lay-in.
Yeah, both teams like to get up and down the floor, so this one could turn into a track meet like we've been talking about.
And if they can shoot well, boy, it'll really be fun to watch as the nice move by Tweet all the way to the basket up and in. Marshall blocked by Lowy. Euler blocked by Lowy. Out of bounds, last touch by White River.
See both big guys from each team making differences at the hoop.
And again, defensively, they haven't even gotten involved on the offensive end yet.
And both these teams like to attack and get to the rim too, so it's gonna be they're gonna play a big part.
Baumberger, who's been big this weekend for Castlewood, goes up top, and then Quincy has it tipped away on the pass inside. Marshall calls out instruction. Mackenzie Weick letting his hair down today, literally in this third place game. Up off the glass, and Marshall can't quite finish. Quincy Thu going to be whistled with the foul. And you'll see it coming right at you. Little bump right there. If you can't stand your ground, they're going to call that a block. And again, you have the right to the spot, but you can't be moving with them, and that's what happened going backwards. Marshall at the free throw line again. Nick, 74% on the year. Misses the first. Averaging right at 20 points a game,
yep.
I believe.
Right at 20, 40 points for the tournament coming in.
And again, that's about 6 points under his season average. He averaged 26 points a game this season, if not the highest, one of the top couple of scorers in the entire state, points per game, regardless of class.
You saw it yesterday, gets to the free throw line a lot too, so if he's struggling from the field a little bit, he's still scoring.
Kessler out top. Now Tweet on the right wing looking for a screen from Thu, goes away from it. Looking for Lowy to come to him. Now they go Baumberger in the corner, the lob. Lowy with the big catch and up and finish. Help was coming, but the big mitts reach up and grab it. Marshall off the glass and good. And the foul called on Quincy Thu. That'll be Quincy's second personal. It's a tough assignment for Quincy Thu. He even gave room that time for Marshall. Marshall does such a good job of using the glass in that situation. Go up over the rim. Make sure you have a good look at it.
Quincy, just such a good defender, too. Big, strong kid. And Marshall just attacking like he has all tournament long.
Marshall comes down, pats him on the butt on that one. Maybe said, I don't know, there's a little contact. Lowy inside, up and good. Lowy will. It is second field goal, and that's what's going to be tough for White River to contend with, I think. And a foul on Ray Crow, reaching in and grabbing the wrist of Brian Lowy.
White River's got length. Euler and Evenstein Wright both at 6'6", but similar to last night, having to go against Kepsel. Kepsel, Lowy, a different kind of height and size, and these guys are wondering what they got to do two games in a row.
Well, and you know, they're There are 6'8 guys out there, 6'9 guys. These guys have really long arms compared to that. And Lowy's just put together. I mean, yeah. he's a Division I defensive end looking type body, you know? Three on the way for Kessler. Catches the rim. Rebound up and in. Bowen Ryan. No, check that. Brody Bass with the putback. Bass has been really good off the bench in spot moments. Marshall just so quick the other way. You got to turn around and see where he is.
That transition defense is going to be big. You got to get back and get your head turned, because if Marshall's not throwing it up the floor, he's driving it down the paint.
If you're Castlewood on the three from Tweet, and he makes one. His first three-point made basket of the tournament.
Bowen Ryan talking transition D, and he picks it off.
Travel. With the travel, we'll go to the media timeout with 4:21 to play in our opening quarter. 13-8 Castlewood. We're back with more on SDPB.
We hope you're a fan of stories about heroes, because we'd like you to meet a few of ours. These folks keep our communities moving forward. They're dedicated to being here for you, navigating change, keeping you secure, and offering a helping hand to those who need it. Heroes come from many walks. Ours are here to walk with you. Go with trust. Go with people. Go with Dakota Bank.
The most gratifying thing about what I do day in and day out is I get to watch things grow.
When you look at corn and the huge role it plays in feed for our cattle and our, you know, our livestock, our pigs is so huge. Also our ethanol plants.
I sit on South Dakota Corn Growers Association. We're focused on policy, so we work with state representatives as well as our state senators and our representative in Washington.
From the Class B boys basketball tournament here in Aberdeen, Northern State University in the Barnett Center, 13-8 Castlewood. Tweet across the timeline, guarded by Mackenzie Weick. He looks for Kessler, gets it to him on way out high. Lob down into Lowy, up, no good. Lowy has own rebound, the putback is good. Brian Lowy, by the way, has played every second of this state tournament so far. And I don't see any difference tonight. The big fella somehow just keeps doing it.
He's been really good, too.
Marshall to the lane. Kessler with the block. Good defense by Kessler. Tweet down the lane. And a foul going to be called on Mackenzie Weick. First personal on Mackenzie. Second team foul. The lob to Lowy. Left block, up with the left hand, no good. Rebound, Evestine Wright had it knocked away by Lowy. Marshall comes out of there with it. On the run, Marshall, hesitation, off the glass and good, and a foul on Bowen Ryan. Look at how quick he just explodes to the rim. Right here, I'm taking it at you, you better be ready. And again, finish off the glass. Every time he finishes off the glass in those situations.
He just goes from when he gathers to go up into that shot. It's quick.
Free throw is good. Four free throws already. Three of four at the stripe. He's been there four times, but made three of them already here in this first quarter. Tweet down the lane. Loses the handle and eventually knocked to the floor. They're going to be on Crow. Foul is called on number five, Ray Crow. That'll be his second personal. Crow going without the headband tonight, I see.
And neither one of these teams is real deep. Castlewood's going to play about two guys off the bench, and White River won, unless foul trouble or other situations dictate it.
Tweet will have a second. And that one is good. Seven in the first quarter for Tweet. his highest offensive output here on the weekend. So he's looking to really good go to the basket.
Yeah, good to see him getting going a little bit.
Evenstein right, swinging across Euler. Baseline against Lowy. Euler will back it out. Marshall to the lane. Jump stop, kick out. Evenstein right three, too strong. Rebound Lowy. The push. Bass off the glass and good. Brody Bass. His second field goal.
And Nicholas Marshall right back attacking the rim.
He just doesn't stop going to the basket ever. We saw him with foul trouble last night. Didn't stop him until, what, fourth quarter, a couple of off that weave up top. And then Kessler all the way to the basket and the foul. Chris Frerich says basket is good. Foul is on number one, Nick Marshall. That'll be Nick's first personal. Kessler.
Lowy's getting a break.
The first time that Brian Lowy has come out of the game this weekend. They got an 8-point lead, make it 9. So a little breathing room, maybe Coach Roush feels like, at least in this moment.
And we talked about it with some other teams. 3 games in 3 days. It gets to be a lot.
Marshall, too strong with the left hand off the glass, off the front of the rim. Kessler. That's a good matchup, too. Kessler and Marshall. Marshall let him go by, and then Evenstein Wright helped out. Saved. White tried to flip it to Euler, but threw it out of bounds. It was a right idea, just threw it too hard.
Just not sure Jordan was quite ready for it.
22-13, and Castlewood willing to run with the White River. That's been the difference here thus far in this opening quarter. Seconds to play in our opening 8 minutes. Tweet, no good, rebound, right. Marshall, lead ahead. White with the left hand up and good. Mackenzie White has 4 points on the assist from Marshall. He averages just about 5 assists a game. Bowen Ryan fires it inside. Baumberger, no good. Flipped it up too hard. White will come away with it. Now the Tigers will push. Ray Crow right side. Little hesitation, he'll get fouled. Can't get the bucket to go, and Brian Lowy will come back. He's gonna have to wait till after the first free throw. Foul called on number 20, Luke Baumberger, his first personal. To the free throw line goes Ray Crow. Chance for his first point of the game. Under a minute to play in our opening quarter.
I'd like to see the percentage of offense that Nicholas Marshall's responsible for, either scoring it or assisting for White River. Seems like he's got a hand in just about everything they do.
Well, and even if he's not, sometimes if he doesn't even get credit for the immediate assist,
the old
hockey situation
assist.
You know what I mean? Like, he leads to that next one because he's pushed it out, made the one good pass for a second good pass kind of thing.
We talked about day one, that opening game, about how well he pushes tempo but knows when to slow it or when to hold up and when to attack.
Yeah. Not sure we got, or do you got stats over there? Mine was just spinning there. It wasn't popping up. We'll see if I can get it to work. Losing the handle on the left side was Kessler. Marshall on the run out against Bass, too strong. Nice job by Brody Bass. Just go straight up, be long. Taken away by Euler. 3-on-1, 3-on-2 now. Lob, Euler, foul. Baumberger going to pick up his second personal. Euler will go to the free throw line. And again, there's a situation where you'll see it coming at you. Nick Marshall, he could attack right here. Take it at tweet. Nope, we'll give it up. Let my teammate go get something. So good decision on his part as well. Euler free throw is good. Took a little while, but it rolled in.
Yeah, Euler's had a good tournament. It's been a big part of the offensive attack for White River. 37 points coming into tonight in the two games.
And that one is good as well. Under 15 seconds to play here in our opening quarter. 22-19, Castlewood. It's another game that we kind of build up to be a great one, and it has been. Tweet starting to shoot it better. He hits the three. Travel. It'll be Castlewood ball with 0.1 seconds, so you can't get a shot, you can't get a tip. As they brought in Jyler Thoroldson, actually. And now we take a break with Castlewood up six. We're back with more on SDPB.
Jackrabbits don't wait to see what the future holds. They build it. At South Dakota State University, the next generation's leaders are preparing to launch. They're focusing on growth, and they're reaching new heights of excellence across vital industries. SDSU is building something greater for South Dakota and the world.
Oh my goodness.
After one quarter of play, 25-19, Castlewood leading White River. 7 of 8 at the free throw line, Steve, for White River here in the first quarter.
Yeah, and we talked about it. That's what they like to do. Not a big outside shooting, perimeter shooting team. They're going to try to get to the rim and get to the free throw line.
Mackenzie White will go to Euler, handoff Marshall. Marshall at the free throw line. Eva Steen right, three, no, off the front iron. He knocked a couple down on opening night, but has not been able to kind of get unleashed. Thu to Tweet. Tweet, long three, feeling it after he's hit a couple. White to Euler. Euler, crossover against Bass. Up and under, no good. Rebound and landing on the line, or somebody touched. So was that Euler standing out of bounds?
Yeah, I think on the came down and threw it off at Euler. He was standing on a bounce.
Kessler now will bring it up. Tweet has it go through the hands and off the chin or the shoulder out of bounds.
Just good guard matchups here, too. I mean, they're Kessler and Tweet for Castlewood and Marshall and White, Crow for White River.
Eva Steen right, swing it out to Marshall. White now, pull up three, no for McKenzie. Tweet took a chance, almost took it away. Bass will bring it across the timeline.
Bass pulls down another rebound. He's been big. First quarter, first half here for Castlewood.
Another one of those super sophomores in this state tournament this year. We've seen a bunch of them. Oof, threw that one under the arms of Wright. Wide left for Tweet. A foul as Marshall comes out of there with it. They're going to be on Bass. Yes, Brody Bass picks up his first personal. First team foul here in the second quarter. 25-19, still a 6-point game. Minute and a half gone in the second period. Lob, Euler. I'm just gonna try to throw that down. Little body underneath there, just in the fact that Lowy was standing there. Euler got a touch on that, and running back into the play.
Tough to throw a lob when you got a 6'9 guy there defending it, too.
They tried to catch him sleeping a little bit, I think. Last touch by Thu. Marshall will inbound after Ray Crow comes back in. Give Mackenzie Wyke a little break. Bowman had checked in. Now Marshall one-on-one with Kessler. Little push off maybe, didn't matter, missed it, got it back. Blocked by Lowey. Saved by Kessler. Jameson will push. In the paint, kick out. Bomberger three, got it on the baseline. He has been huge in moments like that all weekend long.
Yeah, coming into the game, he might as well chalk Bomberger up for about three of those.
Hey, he's going to get 9 points all on threes. That's just how it works. I think it's happened both nights. Marshall to Euler. Euler off the bounce. Swing it out. Lowey will block it, help Euler up after he swats it out of bounds. We talked about Colt Kepsel on that first day. I think, who was it that said it? Oh, it was Coach Heater. He said, you know, Colt Kepsel protects the rim 8 feet on any side of it. Lowey's kind of the same way when he's in that situation, able to come over and help. That was actually his man, but he backed off and then just out of nowhere.
And Euler's so long and athletic, too. He can get by and create space, but Lowey just eats it up. And such a good shot blocker, too, keeping that space, like you mentioned.
Kessler lob, Lowey in and good. Lowey so hard to guard in that situation. Get you buried, then he pushes you up that time. Quickly the other way, Marshall. He's got 12. Stats are down right now. Lowey's at approaching five. That was either his fourth or fifth block shot there on that one that he swatted out. Maybe his fifth already. To check and see what he had last couple nights. Lowey maybe created a little space and got the easy lay-in.
Got away with one maybe, but.
All I want him to do is just go up and dunk one of those. I don't, you know.
We just need one more.
Just one more is all we need. Under five, actually, we're at 4 minutes almost already here to play in this second quarter. Been pretty fast. Backdoor cut. Kessler gets it. The overplay of Crow can't keep up with the quickness of Kessler. Kessler's got seven, and the Warriors are up 13.
Well, you don't see that very often. Marshall with the jump shot.
Bomberger loses it, gets it back, scores it over Evenstein Wright.
Good. Tweet showing how good of a passer he is, too. Threading the needle on a couple.
Blocking foul, and the bucket's good. I think he waved it in, didn't he? Yeah, basket's good for Nick Marshall. He'll have a free throw when we come back. We'll have a foul whistled against Quincy Thu. Back with more on SDPB.
Sometimes having 15 of something is great. Like 15 pizzas. Yo! Nice. But for days of class missed, 15 or more is not so great. The best way for students to own their tomorrow is being present today. See why good habits matter at showupsd.com.
A community is more than buildings. It's where you live. Where you work. Community is being there for each other. Lending a hand when your neighbors are in need. Community is all of us coming together for a greater purpose. This is community. This is Lloyd.
With 3:32 to play here in our first half, Castlewood has put up big numbers, up 13, 36. 23, and I think we're at 13 blocks on the tournament for Brian Lowey. 8 coming in, and he's got 5 here in this first half. Little Johnny Cash in the background. Why not? Might as well, right?
We did get the offenses fired up a bit, so.
True story. Well done. Marshall makes good on the three-point play. 15 in the first half for Nick Marshall.
For as much defense that's been played in all the games in the tournament so far, you can't say that these two teams aren't D-ing it up either. It's just good offense right now.
Yeah, guys are finishing at the rim right now, playing a little more relaxed.
Last game of the year, you can't hold nothing back now, Brad.
That's true story. You've been waiting for 2.5 days to say that. That's beautiful. Jamison Kessler, top of the key now. Interchangeable parts for Castlewood, too. You know, we've seen that with these teams that are guard-oriented. They've got guys that any of them can play the point. Oh, Wyke looking ahead. Marshall back and forth trying to decide. I'll just lay it in left-handed this time. Knicks got 17. Kessler on the baseline. Tipped and just about saved. Bowman, good hustle. Oh, might have popped his shoulder off. See that? He's trying to get it back in. I thought he's going to have to run to the bench there for a second.
Yeah, both teams just so active defensively with hands and deflections and then turning it. They go from off defense to offense in a hurry.
Kessler. Handoff, Tweet, 3. Got it. Lane Tweet stroking it tonight. 15 for Tweet in the first half. Lane hasn't gotten himself wrapped up in calls and no calls as much tonight as we noticed last night. And it's let him just be free and shoot.
Yeah, he looks a lot more relaxed.
Yeah, he's knocking playing. Shots down.
Seen him do that all year. I mean, he's a good shooter, good player.
Ball tipped away, saved by Bauman. Under 10 on the shot clock. Bounce pass, baseline. Marshall, no good. Rebound, another block shot for Lowy, and a foul on Bauman.
Probably not taking that away from Lowy, so maybe just get back on D.
Another one of those guys we said with Colt Kepsel, too. Two hands on the ball, and their hands are so big, they just surround the ball. Like, you can't even get in there and tie it up because you're going to have to grab a hand to get a hold of the ball. 41-26, big first half. Another backdoor cut. Bass flips it out. Bomberger, 3. No. Rebound, Lowy. Up and good. Brian Lowy. Just being Brian Lowy. He's got 12 here in the first half.
And again, Euler at 6'6 was right there, but Lowy just has a knack for timing it and going up to get it.
Euler out to Wyke. Wyke taking a right at Lowy, and Lowy says, not tonight. I'll block that one too. Lowy's got 7 block shots in this first half. That one stays White River basketball on that block. He's had a couple of those where he's just swatted it out of bounds. I'm going to try to win the race with Rosh at halftime. I'm going to watch which way he goes. Takeaway by Castlewood. And losing it out of bounds is Tweet. Turkey or ham? You even seen right to Wyke. Swinging around right, and Wyke will play a little catch. Under a minute to go now in this opening half. Marshall back to Wyke. Wyke swinging left side, Bauman. Inside to Euler, turnaround, blocked again! Lowy! And Tweet comes away with it. Warriors will run. Oh, that's a good no-look. And then Wright was able to get a hand to knock it out of there.
Just not quite a big enough window to get it through there.
Again, we'll have a quick conversation with Coach Roush as they head to halftime. Travel called underneath. And then we'll come back for a special presentation here at Barnett Center. Looking forward to that. with the officials that are here at the state tournament this weekend, and then also in conjunction with Aberdeen Central High School and Aberdeen Chamber of Commerce, all pitching in on something that's going to happen here at halftime, recognizing an individual that has dedicated a large portion of her professional career to what she does and does it really well. 30 seconds to play. Ray Crow will miss the three. Kick it out, Euler. Euler, baseline, back to Crow. Another three on the way. Nothing but the hands of Brody Bass to corral that one. And then under 20 seconds now. 15 on the clock.
I really wish those stats were up because I'd be – Lowy's got to almost be pushing a triple-double right now in the first half.
And I've got eight just in, you know, kind of my tally marks here on my own, but on the block shot side. Tweet will miss it out of the hands of Evastein Wright. And Roush is coming my way. I'm going to beat him to the corner.
All right.
We're going to catch up to him this time. He beat me off the floor last night. He ain't beaten me twice.
Castlewood found the offense, 43 points here tonight. Got it going. Rashi's going to have to feel good about that after struggling to score a little bit, as well as they played defense. But tonight, coming out, putting the ball in the hoop.
Coach Roush joins us. Coach, well, that's a great first half offensively for you guys, shooting the ball with confidence.
Yeah, we're a little more relaxed tonight than we were last night. Guys came in loose and talked about it. We actually talked about, hey, who won the third place game 10 years ago, and nobody could come up with it.
Right.
So, I mean, let's just live in the moment tonight and have some fun, and our guys are doing that right now. But this game's far from over. White River's so explosive, we're going to have to keep doing what we're doing.
Is it about the focus of your kids to continue to play defense like they played this first half, or just changing things up?
I think so. I mean, just keep doing what we're doing, and it's been successful so far. Marshall really hurt us getting to the basket, so we made a little adjustment there. I'm sure they're going to make an adjustment to that this half, but we're going to make some other guys prove it a little bit, and then if they start doing that, we'll go back to what we started with. So.
Fun to watch your kids play this well. Good luck second half.
Thank you.
You bet. Paul Roush, head coach Castlewood, back with that special presentation in just a moment on SDPB.
Dreamer, doer, difference maker. These are just a few things we look for when growing our team at Dakota Bank. Those with empathy and a commitment to doing what's right build their careers with us. If you're about relationships and helping others, Dakota Bank is calling. Will you answer? Go with integrity. Go with teamwork. Go with Dakota Bank.
The most gratifying thing about what I do day in and day out is I get to watch things grow.
When you look at corn and the huge role it plays in feed for our cattle and our livestock, our pigs, is so huge. Also our ethanol plants.
I sit on South Dakota Corn Growers Association. We're focused on policy. So we work with state representatives as well as our state senators and our representative in Washington.
Bioethanol supplies more than just energy. It creates jobs in rural communities. It drives demand for local corn. It provides opportunities for family farms to thrive. To ensure agriculture plays a leading role in the efforts to decarbonize and transition energy, bioethanol remains at the forefront of a pursuit for a cleaner, brighter future for all Americans. Learn how at sdethanol.com.
Coverage of the South Dakota High School Activities Association event is made possible by a partnership between the SDHSAA and SDPB. Sponsors of SDPB's coverage include Dakota Bank, South Dakota Corn, and by Lloyd Companies, Bank West, South Dakota State University, the South Dakota Department of Education, and by your membership in the Friends of SDPB.
From the Barnett Center, 43-26 at halftime. Let's turn it over to our public address announcer, Aiden McCafferty, for a special presentation.
Ladies and gentlemen, please direct your attention to center court for a special presentation. On behalf of the South Dakota Officials Association, the South Dakota Interscholastic Administration Association, and the Aberdeen Convention and Visitors Bureau, we would like to recognize Joe Out for her dedication and leadership with the South Dakota High School Activities Association. For the past 16 years, Joe Auk has served as a student athlete, served student athletes across South Dakota as the Assistant Executive Director. Joe will be retiring at the end of the school year. She has had a tremendous impact on the recruitment of officials, a leading voice for women in sports, and an advocate for all high school athletes. Thank you, Joe, for all that you have done. Your legacy will live on for many years. Here to present some tokens of gratitude. Here to present some tokens of gratitude are region official coordinators Paul Rozelle, David Plantine, Doug Rusink, Jerry Beers, Greg Blue, Jeremy Mickelson, and Larry Osborne. Also presenting are Casey Wisemantle from the Aberdeen Convention and Visitors Bureau and Don Seiler from Aberdeen Public School District. Thank you for your lasting legacy and good luck in your retirement. Once again, let's hear it for Joe Out.
We'll take a break, come back, and hit some stats and highlights, and also catch up with Eldon Marshall. We'll do that when we return here in just a moment on SDPB TV.
There is a new world out there, revealing itself in unpredictable ways. A world that demands more from the land and those who grow, farm, and build on it. This new world calls for the ingenuity to get more out of it while preserving as much as we can. After all, to stay ahead of tomorrow, we need to be equipped for it today.
Dakota Plains New Holland dealers proudly support high school athletics.
At Bank West, our relationships are everything. They reach beyond banking. We're committed to understanding your vision and upholding your values as partners in your success. Building a future filled with opportunity. Bank West.
The word cooperative means working together for a common purpose. At Actegra Cooperative, we are dedicated to supporting the success of our farmers and the health of our communities for generations to come. Rooted in our communities, Actegra strives to instill dedication, determination, and integrity in everything we do, and that includes inspiring the next generation of agricultural leaders.
Be nervous.
A little.
And action!
Bright things ahead, darling. Brightness and joy.
I've got plans.
Everything feels better after a cup of tea.
No, Harkin.
I just want to be right here in this moment with you.
You're going to be a bigger star than ever.
This is good news for all of us.
Best episode ever.
From the Barnett Center at halftime of our third place game, head coach Eldon Marshall joins us. Before we talk basketball, first of all, congratulations on the Larry Luchens Coach's Influence Award last night. What an honor to be surrounded by all former family. I mean, they're all family, teammates and friends.
Yeah, definitely. It's special. I'm very honored, humbled by it. And I'll try and carry on his legacy and in his name as best I can.
Talk a little bit about this first half. Boy, Castlewood has shot lights out. Your kids are playing hard. They're just making shots.
Yeah, we're getting opportunities. You know, we're missing layups. We're getting some. We're like 0-4 or 7 from 3. We just can't hit a shot. So hopefully second half we can knock down some threes.
Anything you change defensively to try to take away the big fella?
You got
to
contain the – it's hard because you got to contain the drive. You know, you got to try and pressure the passers. You know, front end, help side needs to be there better, of course. But we got it. We're pressuring the passer. They're going by us. So it's tough. But our – I believe in our guys, and we'll pick it up defensively second half.
Congrats again. Best of luck second half.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thanks, Eldon. Eldon Marshall, always classy in rough first half here, Steve. Talk about some of these first half stats.
Yeah, Eldon talked about it. You know, White River's only shooting 28%, 9 of 32. Castlewood up at 60%. 4 of 7 from deep for the Warriors. White River, 0 of 7. Free throw line, White River's kind of getting some back there, 8 of 9, and a lot of that's Nick Marshall on going to the basket. Castlewood doing a great job on the boards, 20 to 13 in that area. 10 turnovers for the Warriors, led to a little bit for White River, but, you know, not a big game changer, and White River struggling to shoot the basketball right now. And you heard Eldon say they're going to need to knock a few shots down, continue to do. Thinks he has the right game plan defensively, but it's just executing and being there kind of a step sooner than what they are. And kind of easier said than done. Castlewood's got some athletes, and then you big Brian Lowey down there. So should be a good second half here. 17-point lead for the Warriors, and we'll see. White River won't go away.
You talked about Lowey, his stat line, pretty impressive. They have him for 6 block shots. We kind of had him for 7 or 8, but regardless, he's almost moving in on that triple-double like you talked about.
Yeah, 12.7 rebounds, 6 blocks are the stats that they brought over for us. You know, Lane Tweet hit some shots tonight, 15 points for him. Nicholas Marshall, 18 to lead White River.
Well, it's kind of fun listening to Coach Rosh talk about it too. You know, he's no pressure right now. He's just playing basketball, which, again, that it goes to show there is a lot of pressure on that Friday night and semifinals and in a packed arena, what you're trying to get done. And tonight, let it all hang out and play basketball.
Yep, they're just... You can tell they're just playing loose and relaxed and smiles on the face a little bit more than last night, and which is good to see.
Lane Tweet way out high, thought about the three. He'll drive instead. Well, high off the glass, up and in. So the hot hand of Lane Tweet continues here in the second half.
That's kind of what Coach Marshall talked about, too, is just containing that dribbler. But just like it is with Nicholas Marshall, it's tough to contain Lane Tweet and Jamison Kessler. And great guard matchups all through the tournament.
Over and back call on the mishandle. Well, and again, there are tons of kids and athletes out there that can blow by people. There are tons of kids and athletes out there that can shoot the basketball. But can you put them both together? And that's what these guys do when they finish so well in traffic and around big guys.
Yeah, and you can't sag off them because they'll shoot the three, get up tight, and then they're going to blow by.
Kessler gets the sweet touch to fall.
Lowey went up and wanted to grab that and was sitting on the rim, but kept his hand off it, and it fell in for Kessler.
Whistle on the far side. Foul going to be called out there on Tweet.
Hey, White River's going to need Jordan Euler to get going too. 0-5 in that first half, and you know, had some good looks, but just couldn't get him to fall. He's been a big part of what they've done these first two games.
Well, and I know Eldon talked about the fact that they haven't hit any threes. They didn't shoot a lot of threes last night or the night before. But they do make some once in a while, and they haven't hit any. So there's a good drive by Marshall to try to get him going.
Yeah, and you had mentioned that earlier, too. Evenstein Wright hit a couple that first day against Vibert Hurley, and Coach Schoenfeld's probably watching these last two games and, had to make them against us, but...
Right. Only 7 points in that second quarter for White River, all at the hands of Nick Marshall. Lowey inside, just battling everybody.
And you saw right there, too, Coach Marshall talked at halftime about they got a front, Lowey. And the weak side help was just a half a step late from Euler getting over there.
It would come the other way. Tweet will push it to Thu. To Bomberger, back to Thu. Inside, threw it away as it was actually knocked away by Evenstein Wright. Thu saw Lowey all by himself, and all of a sudden Evenstein Wright popped out from behind him and was able to be right in that passing lane. I don't think Wright thought it was coming. Wasn't ready to catch it either and went out of bounds. Tie some shoes. A lot of bodies making their way inside the Barnett Center once again. I didn't really look up behind us. There's a few seats available way up high here at the seat backs, but Kesler went for the block. Marshall laid it up and in off the glass. 21 for Marshall. Kesler, he can handle it too. He and Parker Graff remind me a lot of each other.
Yeah. Righty and lefty version.
Kesler, sweet jumper from Jamison Kesler. He's got 11. Marshall at tweet, foul. Lane will pick up his second personal. Again, sometimes what do you do? It's definitely a foul. What do you do? You either got to get out of the way or you got to sit down quicker and try to take one.
And we talked about it, you know, kind of ad nauseum all tournament long, but Nicholas just does such a great job of finding angles to attack. He's not going to – rarely does he take you square on
right.
to make it a charge. He's getting to the side of you, and then that's when you're getting dinged for a blocking foul.
And yet he's able to keep his body – squared just to the backboard or to the basket to square his shoulders and finish.
Absolutely, just that body control. And
he's had a ball in his hands a lot in his lifetime. I mean, that's just part of his, you know, dad's had keys to the gym since the day he was born, so he lived there.
We talked about that 19 years that White River's been to the state tournament, and I'm guessing Nicholas is 18 or 19.
Yeah, well,
probably
17 right or 18. Lowy missed that dunk. And there's a foul.
Probably played more games in Barnett Center than actually in White River.
Could be over the years, yeah. Well, media timeout already. 4:55 to play. We'll come back for free throws on SDPB.
We're trying to promote the Descendants of Doom tour. You know, trying to make everybody look kind of metal and, you know.
Menacing.
The band just got covered by Delta Dental, so they kind of can't stop smiling.
They need to look more metal, and they don't look metal. What do we do?
Pop off a few more, see what we get.
Give me some metal. All right, yeah. 3, 2, 1.
Delta Dental!
We're all going somewhere. Going higher, faster, farther. Going in new directions, to new places. At Monument Health, we keep going so you can keep going. We're dedicated to advanced orthopedic care with the latest innovations, technology, expertise, and treatment. So keep exploring. Keep making memories. Keep going with Monument Health as your partner. Learn more at monument.health/orthopedics.
Out of the media timeout. Mr. Josh Kemp will administer the free throws underneath the basket. And Marshall will miss the first, left it short. Didn't get up on his tiptoes going to the hoop that time. He's kind of falling back already as he was shooting that free throw. This time stays straight, left it short again. Chased and saved by Castlewood.
Nick's logged a lot of minutes this tournament too, so you just wonder if the
Tweets blocked by Crow. Legs got to be getting tired, don't they?
Well, and especially as hard and as fast as they play all the
time. Oh, Mackenzie White flips it behind his back. And the finish for Euler, his first field goal of the game. Kesler,
thought it.
Crow will take it away and go the other direction. Kesler catches up quick. But Crow lays it in, and a timeout, Castlewood, 51-36, back to 15.
Now, you know White River's not going to go away.
Yeah, and they can turn you over and get out and run so fast, they can score quickly. But, again, if you're White River, what are you thinking right now? You're down, I mean, obviously it was bigger than this, but now you're down 15. You know, little by little, it's 4-10, you're just a little 5 points at a time.
Yeah, just chunk it up and get it down to single digits or under 10 or at 10 at going into the fourth. And, you know, and hopefully some of those nerves and tighten up and some missed shots and some runouts and continue to create some turnovers and give yourself a chance.
Well, you know, we talked about that this afternoon. Same thing happened in that afternoon game where all of a sudden Weston Springs was trying to hold on for a win.
Yeah, that's what I was just going to mention, that game. You know, and Gregory just changed a few things up and started to get a few shots to fall. Springs started to miss a couple, and then all of a sudden you look up and Gregory's got a chance to tie the basketball game, which they did, and then the Spartans pulled it out.
Castlewood will bring it up.
A little 2-3 zone action for the Tigers.
This shot. Crow in traffic. Last touch. Yeah. Last touch by Euler. Pointed the wrong way first. Again, that's the other thing. Castlewood, they like to get out and go. And like Rosher said, we're playing relaxed. We're just going to play. But sometimes now you got to get smart with the basketball with a lead, too. Maybe not a lot of early quick shots, but they're not afraid to let it fly.
No. And, you know, that's maybe some of what going to the zone, just giving them a different look. And that's similar to the same thing kind of that Gregory did today.
Here it is. The lob and the finish, Euler.
All kinds of athletic from Jordan Euler.
Just to make that catch in traffic and then to be able to score. Coach Rosh not happy right now. In comes Bowen Ryan for Jamison Kessler. 3:11 to play. It's a 13-point game. Somebody else must be. Oh, Lowy's on the sideline. I didn't see. They're working on him over there in the corner. Wondered where the big guy was.
Yeah.
In and out, no good. Rebound, Baumberger. I didn't see Lowy go out, but they're working on him in the trainer's area over there. Every assistant that was on the bench, about 14 people from Castlewood surrounding him over there. Shot on the way for Tweet. Off the front iron, no good. Rebound, Bass. In the paint, kick out, Thu. Thought about the three, step back off the bounce. Got it, Quincy Thu with a big basket.
That's something Quincy's done kind of all year for Castlewood too, is give him that open look, and he's patient on the offensive end and capable of knocking down the three.
Inside Euler, jump stop, step through, and a foul gonna be called. Euler will go to the free throw line. Foul is called on number 5, Brody Bass, his second personal. Euler had 2 points at halftime. He's got 2 buckets here.
Get going a little bit without Lowy in the game. Give him a little more room to operate down low and go to work.
Well, that's the thing. The matchups favor White River a little bit more right now, but there comes Lowy making his way from wherever he was over there.
He got hitting the nose.
Both free throws good for Euler. 4 for 4 at the stripe for Euler. Eleven of 14 at the free throw line for White River. Brody Bass blocked by Eva Steen Wright.
Great shot fake from Brody. Then he just kind of rushed it towards the end and faded away a little bit instead of going up strong through the defense.
Mackenzie White loses the handle, gets it back. Wright for 3 on the top. No. Rebound, Tweet. White River fans in the bench ready to erupt on that, and just can't get one to fall from long distance right now.
Staying in the 2-3 right now.
The skip, Kessler. Right baseline, no. Rebound, Brody Bass on the offensive glass. Baumberger in the paint, and he'll be fouled. Good flash by Baumberger down the lane. The foul called on Eva Steen Wright. Eva Steen picks up just his first personal. And again, no points on the board for Eva Steen. Credit tough matchups. They list him at 6'6", and they list Brody Bass at 6'4". Bass is actually a little bigger than Wright, so I'm not sure which one's lying, but somebody is.
I think Brody's probably growing 3 or 4 inches since the season started, though, too.
Well, I thought you meant since Thursday.
We played Castlewood first game of the year, and
Elliot was guarding it for Pete's sakes.
Not sure about that, but
Wright, or rather Marshall, just the sweet touch. I mean, that ball rattles around the rim, looks like it's going to roll off, falls back in. Tweet picks it up just past half court. Kessler, who came back in, swings it. Bomberger tipped out of bounds. 12-point game. White River did a good job of getting this game back to within reach, though. If they can get a stop and a score at the other end to get it, like you said, 10 or even down to 9. Lowy, though, on the inbound, leaves it short. Lowy going to play with the tissue up his nose. You said he got bopped in the nose there. Evenstein right. Go to Crow on the right wing. Ray Crow, about 5.5 seconds different shot clock to game clock as we wind it down. 15 on the shot clock now. Crow with 10 on the shot clock. Euler at the free throw line, down the lane, and has to swing it out to get it away from Lowy because he's got 6 or 7 blocked shots, and he's able to draw the foul. You'll see it coming right at you. Well, body inside on big Brian Lowy, his first personal. 2 shots for Euler. Wide stance on his free throws, doesn't he? I noticed that before. Left foot's way back, and it's wide. Everybody's got their own style. Again, when you're elementary, junior high kids, you try to teach them the right way to stand. But again, he's shot that way for so long, I'm assuming he's just, that's what's natural for him. Too strong.
Haven't really seen him take any jump shots from the field either, so you don't know what is.
Right. Skip. Kessler three. He's going to get fouled. And Ray Crow will foul Kessler. And Kessler will get 3.
So almost the opposite of for White River, what they wanted or needed to happen there. You talked about finishing with a shot at the end of the quarter.
Kessler misses the first. Crow loves to visit with officials after he's called for a foul, doesn't he? I mean, he doesn't yell at him or anything. He just walks right up to him. He just wants, like, I don't know what. I just watched the interaction. It's kind of fun to watch with those guys. Kessler makes 1 of 2. I hope that's gum that he's doing that with and not a spit bubble. Were you watching that, too?
I did. I saw that.
Kessler will make the second, or the third, rather, 2 of 3. And we will go to our final quarter. 8 minutes to play, 56-42. We're back with more on SDPB.
Lucky for us, life is full of choices, big and small, just as it should be. They define us, make us who we are. And when it comes time for you to choose a car, home, your next big adventure, or start a new business, Farmers Union Insurance has the variety of choices to make sure you have the perfect coverage to protect each perfect moment. Farmers Union Insurance.
Powering the possibilities of tomorrow starts today. For our homes, our farms, our businesses. That's why our Touchstone Energy Cooperative continually plans for the future by utilizing and sourcing safe, reliable power for the next generation. So we can power possibilities long into the future. Touchstone Energy Cooperatives, powering possibilities.
Back out of the quarter break and waiting for teams to join us. Steve, your take on that third quarter.
White River started out how they needed to, and then when Lowy went to the bench, they're kind of making some headway, but then, you know, a couple bad plays at the end, but just
decisions.
Fouling them on a 3, and Euler missed a free throw, and kind of the opposite result of what White River wanted to have happen. Another block for Lowey.
Wow, he's just changing everything right now. 14-point lead, Tweet way out high. In the logo, gets to Bomberger. Lowey down inside. There it is! Brian Lowey with the flush and the fifth dunk of the tournament. Thank you, Levi. 7:20 to play. Tip, Euler will go get it.
It's about the second one that Lowey had like that, right?
Wake. Can't toss it up. Luke Bomberger walked right under the ball, on the shoulder. Not sure why he was just pretending to shoot. He just kind of shot it straight up. But the second dunk he's had like that, you mean?
Yeah. Didn't he have first round game? He had one where he caught it and just a drop step. And
well, that's the stuff he can do. I think he had three dunks against us this year in Castlewood, all on plays like that where drop steps, except he went up and did it with two hands.
Yeah.
But, again, he's long. He's athletic, strong.
2 years ago, we had a team camp in Elkton, and Castlewood came. Would have been Brian was going to be a freshman that year. And we're playing in our North gym, our old gym, and he just went up and Booker Schooley threw an alley-oop to him off the backboard, and he shattered our backboard.
Was that on the south end?
Yep.
Yeah, rims were lower then. Yeah. I remember that one. That was a lower rim. I used to be able to touch that rim. And the throwaway as Marshall zigged when Ivestine Wright thought he was going to zag. You know, you can't see it all the time on camera because we're kind of following the ball more. But if you're in the arena or whatever, watching Nicholas Marshall when they run a set play for him, it's fun to watch him how hard he goes to get from spot to spot the alley-oop. Kessler lobbed that up. Bomberger just about flushed it. All of a sudden, it's turning into a dunk fest. We took the over, and now we can just roll like crazy. 6:49. No, Spencer, there was no betting. That was just how many we thought they'd have. I got to tell my son-in-law, it wasn't really a thing.
Possibly was at Roosters.
Never know. 58-42. Thu, second free throw, no good. Wright will go get the rebound. Block. Lowey. 9 rebounds, 8 block shots now to go along with 16 points, a phonetic dunk. And he's just kind of taken over.
I put an asterisk by that block, too, because I agree. I think he's got a few more than what this one is.
Bomberger. They're just playing catch out there. It's like open gym right now. Kessler, leg Willie hits the three. Jamison Kessler, a fadeaway and knocks it down. Kessler the steal. Knocked out of bounds by Wright. And a block back to 19 just like that.
Coach Rosh has got to love seeing his kids with a smile on their face and playing loose like they are right now.
5 seniors on this Castlewood team, 7 juniors, though, and then some sophomores. Really,
they got some good kids, younger kids, too, that are coming up. So
yeah, they're going to be really good here. Well, the next couple of years, so Castlewood's not done playing in the Barnett Center if they want to stick with it and work as hard as they have been to get here. White just about took it away. To the lane, Bomberger in traffic, foul on Ivestine Wright. Ivestine will pick up his second. He saw his visit with Coach Rasha at halftime. Went with the plaid shirt tonight. Usually he's got the blue. It's kind of a blue plaid, I guess. But it's always the Castlewood blue almost all the time. Same shirt. He washes it. I mean, it's not, But, again, changed it up. And all of a sudden, they're shooting the ball like crazy tonight. So, never know. See what happens. Back in the days at Lankford, didn't he have a maroon one, a maroon and gold one?
Yeah. Rotated those two. saw that here in the Barnett Center a number of times, too.
Yep. He's no stranger to this coaching on this floor. Hey, Euler at the other end at the alley-oop dunk. We might hit the mark in this game alone. Marshall, up and good. 5:25 to play here in the fourth. 16-point game. You can't stop playing, can you? You got to still play defense. Much fun as you're having on offense, you've got to play defense against these two teams or they'll score so quickly.
That's what Rashi's telling him, too. You know, focus and settle down a little bit, telling Jameson and Lane that.
Yeah, he was really letting
them
know.
Get the ball, and you guys got to take charge and get us under control.
Yeah. Marshall setting the offense, directing traffic.
Castlewood went to a 2-3, kind of a matchup that they play out of it a little bit.
Really denying. It's more of a diamond and one, I think, right now.
Yeah,
Kessler way out here on Marshall.
They kind of just put Lowy in the middle, too, and then everybody else is playing a zone. So,
well, when you got a shot blocker like that, I mean, you can do that, you know?
Brian, you just take the paint. We'll run around and guard people out here.
I mean, we've all gone through coaching years. You've had them where you've had that big guy that you can take different chances on the perimeter because of it. Crow will run out on the loose pass, lose the hand. He'll get it back. And then dump it down to Euler. Good pass.
Euler was calling for the alley-oop when Ray just kind of
I think he was going to throw it,
too,
and lost it off his hands. Now it's 14 already. Corner, tweet, back to Kessler. Down the lane, Kessler leave it for Lowy. Under the hoop, and then just be mauled by Evastein Wright. Josh Kemp steps in. I got it. We got the call. Everybody was wanting something different. We'll go to our media timeout with 4:09 to play. 62-48, we're back with free throws on SDPB.
What does primary care mean to us? At Sanford Health, it means being there when and where you need it most. It means building a relationship, because when a provider really knows you, they can deliver the best care for every aspect of your health and your life. So what does primary care mean for you? It means understanding your health for today and for where you're headed next. It means a lifetime of care for a lifetime of you.
We all need insurance to protect our health, our homes, our belongings, and our businesses. But coverage is just the beginning. You also need the support of professionals who stand by your side to protect what's important to you. Fisher Rounds and Associates combines the coverage you want with the commitment you need. Fisher Rounds and Associates, at your service, at your side.
Media timeout, number four. And that takes us to the last 4 minutes of this one. Again, putting Lowy at the free throw line. Could go back to 16 here, but White River's had chances, Steve, to just climb back in this and just haven't been able to capitalize. They've given up some big plays on the defensive end.
Yeah, Castlewood's answered. You know, they cut it down to 14, had a chance there towards the end of the third. Castlewood responded, so what good basketball teams do. So, you know, White River's probably got another good run in them here to make a run at it. So,
Lowy's shot on the way is good. First free throw. Lowy with 17. 17 now, I think, in the game. I'll recheck that in a minute. Eight of 13 from the field. 17 in the game now.
Crow misses the three in the corner. Just White River just cannot get a jumper from the outside to fall.
Kessler. It's Sweet, down the lane, lob it up, hit the rim, otherwise Lowry was there to go up and try to put it in. Euler traveled. Caught it, took three. Jamison Kesler with 3.5 minutes to play across the timeline versus Mackenzie Wyke. Lowry still working for position down low. And Bomberger with another three. Crow, he'll shoot the three from the left wing and get one. Ray Crow finally able to knock down a three-point shot. He's had a couple of opportunities. That one, he looked good right from the beginning.
Yeah, good catch and shoot in rhythm. And
Tweet, turn around, no good, rebound. Lowry. Kesler out there versus Crow. They'll throw it over the top. Evenstein right. And Lowry will go up and flush another one. And a timeout, Castlewood. The Warriors going to talk it over. That was, here, look at this finish. Get out of my way. All right, I'm by myself. One-handed. Whole thing's shaking.
You know, Nick Marshall came for the backside help a half a step late. He knew it was going to happen, so just kind of got out of the way.
Yeah, well, it didn't come to me. I don't want to ride that arm all the way up.
I don't need to be on the SDPB poster for next year.
Not at all. 2:32 to play, 69-51. Castlewood has really, just from the very start tonight, took control early. White River, you know, they're playing hard. They just can't get shots to go down. And every time they get a 4 or 5 point run, Castlewood answers with one of their own.
Yeah, they really struggled shooting the basketball. White River did early in the game. And that's when Castlewood kind of built that lead a little bit.
There just hasn't been three times in the second half where White River's been able to get runouts, get layups. I mean, there just hasn't been that. And that's what they make a living on.
Yep.
Marshall got it, and a three. And now he's like, yeah, now I start making them. He says, Nick Marshall, 28 in the game, 11 of 22, 6 of 9 at the free throw line. And that's where he's going to be frustrated that he missed 4 free throws tonight.
Yeah.
Not that that was going to make the difference in this game right now, but again, a competitor like he is. Lowry gets the loose ball. Kesler, right baseline. He'll drive, step back. Bomberger blocked out of bounds by Marshall. Has a chuckle with the Castlewood guys out of bounds.
Weren't sure if they were going to catch him going into the bench or not.
Brody Bass will come in for Luke Bomberger. Bomberger, 6'4 junior, he'll be back. Kesler, 6 foot junior, he'll be back. Lowry, 6'9 junior, he'll be back.
Thanks for the reminder.
You bet. Kesler up off the glass and in with the left hand. Marshall hard to the floor.
You haven't really seen Nick get that. First half had those types of opportunities, and Castlewood did a really good job with transition defense, but some of that comes from Castlewood shooting such a high percentage too. There's not a lot of missed shots for them to get out and go on.
Yeah, for sure. The 5 seniors on this Castlewood squad: Lane Tweet, Quincy Thu, Cabron Jackson, who I believe we're going to see come in, Tyler Jutter Thirldson. And who am I missing? Oh, Bowen Ryan. So it looks to me like the 5 seniors for this Castlewood team will be all on the floor together one last time. May have one more sub with 5 guys on the bench. Or 5 of 6 anyway. And then we'll bring the seniors out to their due applause, I would think. We'll see what happens. Eva Steenwright, 6'6 senior, comes out. Jordan Euler, 6'6 senior, comes out. Nick Marshall will make his last shot as well. Take his last shot maybe as a White River Tiger. Missed the free throw.
Nick's like, I don't want to come out.
And he's going to right now. Watch this round of applause from the White River faithful, I would think.
And very well deserved.
Yes. Comes to dad. Always a tough one. That's a great picture. They've battled. White River's been here over and over. They had high hopes coming in as a one seed. Mackenzie White, just a 5'8 junior, he's going to be fouled. Ray Crow, another senior for this White River team, still on the floor.
You know, and White River played the part all season, all tournament long, too.
In will come Tristan Bearheels, another senior for White River. Directing traffic out there.
Everybody trying to bring their seniors off to get that one last standing ovation and applause from the crowd.
Ray Crow will come out.
Trying to figure out who's coming out when.
Mackenzie White, just a junior, but he'll come out. Three on the way. Catches the backboard on the way by for Bryson One Star. Just an eighth grader. Got to shoot one in the state tournament. Minute 10 to play. Bowen Ryan. Backdoor cut. Good tipped pass. Away.
Good pass from Bowen.
One Star. Flip it around. Bowman in the paint, no good, rebound. Saved, and Bowen Ryan will bring it up across the timeline for Castlewood. The Warriors will be your third place winners here at the Class B State Tournament in 2024. Again, with a couple of more made shots last night. You know what? They're playing for a title in the next game.
Yeah, and same thing with White River. I mean, this very easily could have been the game coming up next.
Bowen Ryan with the three.
Another round of subs here.
Bowen hits a triple. His last shot as a Castlewood Warrior. 74-54, a 20-point game right now for Castlewood. The Warriors are celebrating over there. We have one more guy to try to get in, it looks like, for Castlewood. Battle for the rebound. Last touch. Lars Tweet is going to get in. The freshman, younger brother of Lane, 5'11 freshman, will come in. Out will come number four, Bennett Johnson. They will just dribble it out. And the Castlewood Warriors with a 20-point victory. 74-54. As seniors have played their final games for these two teams. You talked about it earlier, Steve. Castlewood from the very beginning, they played loose, and they just played their style of game tonight.
That's the Castlewood team you saw all year long, you know, playing relaxed, playing confident, and, you know, and I think just maybe a little bit of pressure felt like, and very easily, like you just mentioned, very easily could be playing this next game coming up you know, if a couple shots fall last night differently, but good to see them bounce back. And you know, Coach Rosh was going to have them ready to play. That's how he is and who he is. And
yep.
It showed. His kids came, strapped it on, and got after it again tonight. And same with Eldon and his crew. I mean, we've said that. They've been here 19 years in a row. Great group of White River again. They were fun to watch play all 3 days.
Yeah, there's not a lot of rebuilding that happens in programs like that. It's just reloading, you know, and they come back and they're year after year after year. As soon as we're ready over on the sideline, Aiden McCafferty, we can take it away.
At this time, we would like to present the awards to the teams that placed third and fourth. To present the award is Joe Out from the South Dakota High School Activities Association. Assisting with the team award presentation are representatives from the Activity Association corporate partners, Dr. Jake Miller of Sanford Health, Belinda Weller of Dakota Bank, Sergeant First Class Brent Wink, and Staff Sergeant Missy Weigel of South Dakota Army National Guard. The fourth place team in Class B is the White River Tigers. Nicholas Marshall. Mackenzie Weick. Ray Crow. Evastine Wright. Bryson Onestar. Cooper Baxter. Riley Bauman. Tegan Bauman. Jordan Euler. Maxon Dupree. Tristan Bearheels. Makai Krogman. And Jace Hutchinson. Assistant coach, John Petrick. Justice Morrison. And head coach, Eldon Marshall.
Did you name off any of the ball boys?
Like for them?
Yeah.
I can, yeah. Welcome home. We'll be at the Barnhart Gymnasium Sunday, March 17th at 4 p.m. Central. Your third place team in Class B is the Castlewood Warriors. Bowen Ryan. Lane Tweet. Quincy Thu. Bennett Johnson. Brody Bass, Cabren Jackson, Camden Kessler, Odie Wernke, Luke Bomberger, Jamison Kessler, Tyson Manley, Colby Davis, Lars Tweet, Brian Lowy, and Jyler Theraldson. Video and stats, David Prohl, Cooper Thu, Taylen Olson, Davis Gales, managers Lincoln Pribnow, Easton Rise. Assistant coach Jeff Sinking. And head coach of the Castlewood Warriors, Paul Rosh. Castlewood, welcome home. We'll be in the Ramcota Oz Room following this game. Team pictures for the White River Tigers will be in the southeast corner. Pictures for the Castlewood Warriors will be in the northeast corner.
As we send you away for a moment, we'll come back here with stats and highlights of this third place game. 74-54, it was all Castlewood. The Warriors back with more on SDPB.
As much as you have accomplished, there are times you'd rather not go it alone. While you determine what direction you go, we're here to help along the way. So go. Go with community. Go with neighbors. Go with understanding. Go with support.
The most gratifying thing about what I do day in and day out is I get to watch things grow.
When you look at corn and the huge role it plays in feed for our cattle and our, you know, our livestock, our pigs is so huge. Also our ethanol plants.
I sit on South Dakota Corn Growers Association. We're focused on policy. So we work with state representatives as well as our state senators and our representative in Washington.
Powering the possibilities of tomorrow starts today. For our homes, our farms, our businesses. That's why our Touchstone Energy Cooperative continually plans for the future by utilizing and sourcing safe, reliable power for the next generation. So we can power possibilities long into the future. Touchstone Energy Cooperatives, powering possibilities.
I decided to switch my major. I didn't want to do sports anymore, so I decided Southeast Tech would be a good one for me to go. The current instructor is a captain with the Highway Patrol. He had a lot of experience and knowledge about the job. I serve the people just as much as they serve me.
Beginning April 6th, watch SDPB Saturday evenings for a new lineup of shows. Start the night laughing with Keeping Up Appearances at 5, 4 Mountain. Then, the drama unfolds with back-to-back episodes of Midsummer Murders tag along with private investigator Alexa Cross in My Life is Murder at 7, 6 Mountain, followed by the fan favorites Doc Martin and Father Brown. Plus, Sister Boniface joins us on Sunday evenings at 6, 5 Mountain.
And we're back inside the Barnett Center as the state championship teams have started to their warm-ups, DeSmit and Howard. Let's recap that third place game. Castlewood right from the beginning came out on fire. Lane Tweet really got it rolling here for Castlewood tonight.
Yeah, Castlewood shooting 52-53% for the game compared to 37% for White River, and led to the difference in rebounding too, 43 rebounds to 21. Castlewood obviously turned the ball over a little bit more. White River just wasn't able to convert all those into points and keep it a little bit closer. And you see a big discrepancy, too, in the three-point field goals. Ray Curl finally hit one down the stretch for White River, but 1 of 13 from the line, 8 of 14 for Castlewood. You know, like Brad said, they came out from the get-go, played loose, shot the ball well, jumped out ahead, and took care of business.
I don't know, when you come out, play loose, play with smiles, you know, play together, get balls up, get them back. It's so much easier to shoot, so much easier to play. And I know sometimes defense spurs offense. I get that. Sometimes good shooting lets you play harder on defense, too, because you're just a little more confident and relaxed.
Yeah, you see the basketball go through the hoop. It makes everything better. Everybody feels a little bit better. And, you know, you've seen it kind of all tournament long. When guys are missing shots or teams are missing shots, things just tighten up even more.
Here's some of those highlights from the second half. I'm sure you'll see a dunk or two here as 3 points rain down and they're able to get the ball. There's another swat, one of the 8-block shots that Brian Lowy was credited with. There's the snap of the rim on one of them. There's a alley-oop two-hand flush for Euler at the other end. 20 points, 12 rebounds, 8 assists. There's the other dunk for Lowy for Brian tonight. That was his stat line, 9 of 14 shooting. and also went 2-for-2 from the free throw line. They picked up 18 points and 7 assists from Jamison Kessler, 17 points for Lane Tweet tonight. On the other side, Nick Marshall, 31 points to go along with 3 assists. He was 12-of-23 from the field, 0-for-1 at the 3-point line, and 7-of-12 from the free throw line. 12 points for Jordan Euler tonight, 7 rebounds for Evastein Wright for the Tigers. And that's how we wrap up our third and fourth place matchup. We'll take a break, come back, special a little presentation, a little package that we want to show you, and then we'll get you set and ready for our championship game of Class B boys basketball. We'll wrap up 2024 coming up on SDPB.
Our teams are committed to improving quality of life in our communities. Whether we're planning construction concepts, building a new downtown development, bringing new businesses to our communities, or maintaining your apartment home. We believe everyone deserves a well-built and well-managed place to live and work. This is Lloyd.
The word cooperative means working together for a common purpose. At Actegra Cooperative, we are dedicated to supporting the success of our farmers and the health of our communities for generations to come. Rooted in our communities, Actegra strives to instill dedication, determination, and integrity in everything we do, and that includes inspiring the next generation of agricultural leaders.
Jackrabbits don't wait to see what the future holds. They build it. At South Dakota State University, the next generation's leaders are preparing to launch. They're focusing on growth, and they're reaching new heights of excellence across vital industries. SDSU is building something greater for South Dakota and the world.
Sometimes having 15 of something is great, like 15 pizzas. Nice. But for days of class missed, 15 or more is not so great. The best way for students to own their tomorrow is being present today. See why good habits matter at showupsd.com.
The Barnett Center filling up even more than it was already. And thank goodness, because it's warming up in here now. So that's good, because it was cold for a little while. Hey, in most of South Dakota's sports bars, you're going to see local sports teams displayed on the walls. The Blue Goose in Oneida takes it to a whole nother level by not just promoting the local teams of Sully Buttes, but teams from all over the state of South Dakota.
Welcome to the Blue Goose.
Jamie Lamb said, when you do this bar, you got to name it the Blue Goose, because everybody called this old bar in town the Blue Goose, and that was its nickname. And I said, let's do it. It's we ran with it. We were kind of searching, and it worked, I guess. So it started really simple. We four of us came together. We were just going to kind of have a clubhouse. And we got a liquor license, and I had all this stuff that I've been collecting for years, and I said, let's throw it on the walls and see what happens. And unofficially, the first non-smoking bar in South Dakota. When we opened, we went non-smoking, and which is kind of cool. It was before the law went into effect, but people come in, they feel like they're in somebody's basement or a garage or somewhere with all this stuff, and they walk around, and there's memorabilia from all over the state, so get a lot of old schools and things that aren't even schools that aren't even in, no longer have schools, they're co-ops now, you know, and that's some of the stuff we really like. Mobridge football jersey, Bronx, you know, every imaginable side of the state people bring in. People come in and they can really relate to you know, can you believe they wore that short of shorts or that jersey material or whatever, you know? And I've been in the sporting goods world for 30 years selling to colleges and high schools, and so it's kind of a, it's a passion for me. I love collecting old stuff like that, and people come out of the woodwork and bring us stuff.
Java scoreboard donated by the Beal Boys out of Java. Braun Trucking, independent basketball. Lots of old memorabilia, and then helmets. You know, we have a lot of great selection of helmets that have come, and ranging from old leather helmets up to modern day stuff.
Well, just like any kid, you started with sports cards, and you know, you bought, sell, trade, and my wife and I collect antiques, and everywhere I went, I was always finding old sports stuff, leather helmets and things, and I was kind of enthralled in it. I just kept collecting, and the Tim Miles jersey right back there, Dolan High School, I didn't know I had it. Tim's a good friend of mine. He went to college with my wife at University of Mary in Bismarck, and we're having supper. We went to supper with him at the Cattlemen's. We're sitting there. I said, Tim, what was your high school number? And he said, 3233. So I called the bartender. I said, take a picture of that Dolan jersey. And I show it to him, and he goes, that's my high school jersey. I got a lot more stuff. There's more to come. I've talked with a couple buddies. We've talked about possibly expanding, if we can find the right town, to another Blue Goose out there somewhere, and spreading the what we have here and into another small town if things would work out right. You know, Oneida is so rich in tradition of state championships, you know, and having good sports teams. And, you know, so after sports events, there's people that come down, they want to talk the sports and the games. And, you know, we have a lot of people in the area that come down here, even they're from the other towns, want to stop and have a pizza and a beer after the games and talk sports. And a lot of people gravitate to here and they say, hey, I got to see the Blue Goose. I heard about this, or, you know, and it's so rich in tradition. And it's a town that, you know, lives and dies on athletics.
What does primary care mean to us? At Sanford Health, it means being there when and where you need it most. It means building a relationship, because when a provider really knows you, they can deliver the best care for every aspect of your health and your life. So what does primary care mean for you? It means understanding your health for today and for where you're headed next. It means a lifetime of care for a lifetime of you.
At Bank West, our relationships are everything. They reach beyond banking. We're committed to understanding your vision and upholding your values as partners in your success, building a future filled with opportunity. Bank West.
Established in 1986, the Great Plains Tribal Leaders Health Board represents 18 tribal communities located in South Dakota, North Dakota, Nebraska, and Iowa. Our vision is that all tribal nations, communities, and citizens achieve optimal wellness through the embrace of traditional cultural values and innovative and holistic healing practices, strengthened by tribal sovereignty. For more information on our grant programs, health services, and career opportunities, visit our website at greatplainstribalhealth.org.
This is the PBS app. It's ready for you whenever you want full episodes of your favorites. Perhaps a little history, or the real story, shows with heart, or the latest news and docs. Even stream your local station live. It's all there waiting for you. So download the PBS app now for everything you love and a whole lot more to explore. Stream anytime, anywhere with the PBS app.
And we're back inside the Barnett Center. I'm Brad DeBeer alongside Steve Erickson, ready for Class B championship action. 12 games this weekend. I had 12 games last weekend, and you know, 20 wasn't a lot of basketball over the last 2 weekends, but it all has built up for what should be a dandy in the Class B Boys Championship.
Yeah, this should be a really good one. Two teams that pride themselves on playing great defense and timely offense, and you've seen it both games each of these have played to get themselves in this moment. Great atmosphere in the Barnett Center here. It's going to be a fun one.
Let's talk about these two teams, the Bulldogs and the Tigers, as D. Smith will actually be wearing their road burgundies. They're the visitors on the scoreboard out of Kingsbury County. Jeff Grunhagen, the head coach. 51, the enrollment, maroon and gold, college boy, the school song. They're going for their fourth straight state title. Beat Arlington and Dubrook in the regions. Knocked up Timberlake in that SODAC 16. A three-point win over Gregory. Three-point win over Castlewood. All they do right now is keep the scores low and win tight games, but that's what good teams do. Tom Onbaugh, Trace Van Regenmorter, X-Factor guy, number 15. Remember that one tonight. Caden Fast, Britt Carlson, and George Jensen. The starting lineup for the Bulldogs. Let's take a look at the Howard Tigers, wearing the home whites with orange numbers and black outline. Out of Minor County, Nick Kepsel, the head coach. 88, I should say. The enrollment, orange and black, college boy, their school song. Beat Mitchell Christian and Chester. Beat Phillip. Scores are very similar, aren't they? It's eerie. Yeah. Beat Westington Springs and White River. A 15-point win to open up the tournament, but then that 6-point victory over the number one seed last night to advance to this game. Colby Clausen, 6-foot senior. Logan Mentally, Taden Hoyer, Luke Kepsel, and the 6'8 senior center, Colt Kepsel, the starting lineup for the Tigers. We got a great story about them as we go through the game tonight. Here it comes, two teams that can keep teams to low scoring, but they can also win close games.
Yeah, these two teams met back January 9th, I believe it was. DeSmet pulled out a 10-point win in that one. It's going to be a great one. Buckle up and be ready for some good basketball.
Great basketball to be played straight ahead of us, 32 minutes away from deciding our 2024 Class B State Boys Basketball Champion. You're watching it right here live on SDPB. Here's Aiden McCafferty.
Welcome back to the state championship game between the DeSmet Bulldogs and the Howard Tigers. Let's meet the starters in alternating fashion first for the visiting Bulldogs. 6 foot senior number 3, Tom Onbaugh. For the Tigers, 6 foot senior number 10, Colby Clausen. For the Bulldogs, 6'4", senior number 15, Trace Van Regenmorter. For the Tigers, 6 foot senior number 14, Logan Mentelli. For the Bulldogs, 6'1", senior number 21, Caden Fest. For the Tigers, 6'2", senior number 22, Taden Hoyer. For the Bulldogs, 6'4", senior number 23, Brett Carlson. For the Tigers, 6'4", junior number 24, Luke Kepsel. And for the Bulldogs, 6'6", senior number 33, George Jensen. In the middle for the Tigers, 6'8", senior number 32, Colt Kepsel. Coaches for the Bulldogs, Clifford Geyer, Becky Geyer, Dustin Olson, head coach, Jeff Gruenhagen. Coaches for the Tigers, Kennedy Kepsel, Ryan Spader, and Nick Kepsel. Officials for today's game, Joe Schroeder, Jordan Gao, Darren Lorenz, alternate official Kevin Ball.
And we are ready to tip it up.
So I got a text from Mr. Ostrine back in Brookings. Said he was a high school student in Howard in the early 60s. Went to the B tourney three times, winning it the last year. They were undefeated the first 3 years of 11-man football. Had one tie with DeSmit. No playoffs back then. In 1956, Howard won the State B. Howard St. Agatha won the St. Catholic tournament. Maybe the only town in South Dakota to have two state championships in the same year, or for a long time that had happened. As Howard wins the tip and we're underway. Talk about him and they get the basketball first. Mentally swings it around. Lawson gives it to Luke Kepsel to the lane. Kepsel, and a foul on George Jensen right off the bat. That's something that the Bulldogs do not want to see happen, is George Jensen getting foul trouble.
Luke Kepsel picking up where he left off two games for Howard. He's kind of been the catalyst to get things going.
Yeah, just a good drive. He's a big body kid that can take it off the bounce, though, get to the lane. And Howard will open up the scoring with a free throw.
Luke just does a really good job of playing under control and not getting, doesn't let people speed him up. And
left-handed, too. takes sometimes, again, kids sometimes aren't used to guarding left-handers, so it's just a little different when they come at you. Then Reagan Mortar, the right elbow.
Colby Clausen on Tom Onbaugh. Tommy had a couple threes, or at least one. I know last night, a big one, and looking to get himself going.
Yeah, he's not giving any help, is he? He's staying out there. He's not going to help anywhere. Fast for three. Caden Fast with a jumper from deep.
DeSmit comes with their 2-2-1. Howard patient and breaks it.
Way out high. Colby Clausen will reset mentally, looking in for Kepsel. Kepsel guarded by Van Regenmorter. He always draws the big guy. Leaving their feet to pass, and then the turnover. Carlson will push ahead. On ball. Kick it back to Fast. Back to on ball now. Tommy off the dribble penetration, loses it. Colt Kepsel comes up with it. He'll push ahead down the sideline. Back to Kepsel down the middle. Kepsel up and in. Colt Kepsel to give the go, the finish.
Kind of lost where he was in transition. He's the one that kind of started the break, and I don't think Van Regenmorter realized where he was when he came down.
Really good push ahead, too, you know. Pass the ball ahead diagonally and get it running.
You got a big guy that can put it on the floor and get it going like Colt just did.
George Jensen, and a foul going to be called on Kepsel. Colt will pick up his first personal.
George has been really good. Yeah, he's been really good all tournament long, starting with that first game and the bank to get him onto Friday night and then eventually here.
Yeah, it seems like an eternity ago that he hit that three-point bank, so you hardly even remember it, right over there in front of where Nick Kepsel's standing right now. Fade away over a 6 foot 9 inch high jumper. And George goes 1 of 2. That pressure just to slow Howard down a little bit. Luke Kepsel push it up to Clausen. Clausen on the right wing. Now Hoyer swing it to mentally inside. Luke Kepsel gives it up. Three-pointer, no good. Jensen got a hand on it. Colt Kepsel was coming in to rebound, couldn't get to it. Three-pointer, Britt Carlson, no. Rebound, Van Regenmorter. Gives up to Carlson, no. Rebound, Kepsel, and a foul from behind on Britt Carlson. Britt will pick up his first. You know, we talked about the length and the reach of Colt Kepsel and how hard he works. I'm impressed with how quick he is. I mean, just running straight up and down the floor. He plays golf for the Tigers. So he's got that, he probably drives it about 360 with those long arms. But He sprints the floor when he gets going. Well, he gets out quick.
Yeah. Doesn't take very many steps either with those strides.
Yeah, doesn't have to.
You see the pressure from DeSmit causing the turnover there. It really went to that 2-2-1 kind of early in the year and found some success with it. And they don't trap hard out of or anything, but they just try to get teams to speed up and
play at a level that they don't want. Get people with the basketball in the wrong position, right?
You try
to get bigs bringing the ball up or catching on the run or whatever. Carlson saves the air ball. Now Kepsel will lead the break. Give it up to Luke Kepsel, then go sit out in the post. One-on-one with Jensen. Through traffic and a foul. George will pick up his second and will go to immediate timeout. As Darren Lorenz says, timeout. We're taking it a minute right here on SDPB.
You live life on the move. While you determine what direction that may be, we're here to help along the way. So go. Go with values. Go with friends. Go with support. Go with convenience.
The most gratifying thing about what I do day in and day out is I get to watch things grow.
When you look at corn and the huge role it plays in feed for our cattle and our, you know, our livestock, our pigs is so huge. Also our ethanol plants.
I sit on South Dakota Corn Growers Association. We're focused on policy, so we work with state representatives as well as our state senators and our representative in Washington.
Back inside the Barnett Center. We are ready for free throws out of the media timeout. I don't know if I told you this, I lived in Howard for a year when I was 3 years old. My dad was the head basketball coach for a couple years at Howard.
I did my student teaching at Howard and started coaching there.
I never coached there, but I did student teach sixth grade with Miss Nell Button as well.
Coach C team basketball. Ryan Walter was the head coach at the time and Chad Statham the assistant. Helped those guys for about 3 years, and when I was in college at ESU.
Student taught for 3 years, interesting.
Student taught for one, you know what I'm saying.
6-4 our score.
Sometimes it felt like that.
Yeah, 4:20 to play. Grant Wilkinson has checked in, so here's a battle to watch now. Kepsel and Wilkinson. Look at Colt really get down low, use his legs for leverage, and then explode and block the shot of Wilkinson.
Grant just good post position.
So hard to keep him from getting that spot. You tell kids, don't let him have it. But
well, and then on this end, too, watch him just drive Colt out. You're not going to post up where you want to.
Kepsel spin move with the left hand up and good. Luke so dangerous because he is left-handed. And you put him on one block, you put Colt on the other. It's hard to give help because the other are such good passers, too. On ball, fumbles it, gets it back. Clawson guard on ball. Wilkinson in the paint all the way across. Couple dribbles.
Trying the same move that Colt did down here on him.
Not going to be quite as quick, maybe. And the bucket by Fast. Caden Fast has 5 points. And the 2-2-1 has dropped off. 8-6 Howard early on.
Talked about Kessler earlier being like Parker Graff. Kind of reminds you. Caden Fast, another one that kind of that same mold. Just a quick twitch and good athlete. Plays off 2 feet and really uses that jump stop to his advantage.
Kepsel got it! Bucket's good and a foul on Grant Wilkinson. Kepsel's got 6 points early on. This is how they got started on opening day. Colt Kepsel got going early. Luke Kepsel had a few buckets. And then everybody else started to fill in because they had to give so much help on those two guys.
And then, you know, a positive for Howard, too. Colt scoring the basketball, but picks up 2 fouls on George Jensen. Another one on Grant Wilkinson. And DeSmit doesn't play a ton of kids off the bench. They got some more that'll come in.
Yeah, but they very seldom go more than one or two deep. If they play seven guys, that's a big night for them.
It's because of foul trouble or something else happened.
Or they're way ahead.
Yeah.
Because they haven't been way behind. So that's not a thing.
Doesn't happen.
No, that's not a thing. Britt Carlson, three on the way. Got it! Carlson with the triple. Again, so many weapons for DeSmit as well. Nobody that goes out and puts up 20, but just so many guys that can score when called on.
Austin Severson in the game for the Tigers. He came in the last first round in yesterday and came in and knocked down a three-pointer, I think, both games.
Will Meyer as well. Luke Kepsel can't get that one to go. Grant Wilkinson will corral the rebound. And then Onball will bring it up. Onball guarded by Clausen. Gets a big screen by Grant Wilkinson. Then Clausen back out to deny Onball. Carlson to Van Regenmorter. And Regenmorter to Carlson. Blocked by Kepsel. They'll say foul on the arm. Jordan Gow will report it as number 24 in white. Colt Kepsel going to check back in after this first free throw. Take a moment, and Luke going to tie his shoe. One rabbit ear, two rabbit ear. Ink the knot, pull it through. There we go. All good. 1:55 to play. In our opening quarter, Britt Carlson with 4 points on that made free throw. Colt Kepsel comes back in, out goes Severson. Yeah, got a feeling, you know, Luke Kepsel, Colt Kepsel, both got to stay out of foul trouble. They're going to have to just get quick bursts of rest, you know, a quick 30 here, a quick minute here, steal some quarters, that or quarter breaks.
Yep, you try to steal some time at the end of quarters if it's possible. And
the lob, Kepsel, pushed off the block again, but quick. Doesn't get turned all the way around, but fires it up off the glass and in. I talked to his dad, Heath, before the game and said, you nervous? No, not yet. He hasn't uncrossed his arms yet. I'm going to say he's nervous right now. Out high, Van Regenmorter. Fast on the left wing. Caden, pull up. No good. Rebound. Wilkinson just lit a little body on Luke Kepsel, and that was enough to knock it away. Then it's thrown away as Onball can't grab it. I think Nick Kepsel is talking to Joe Schroeder about that, too. Thought that Wilkinson maybe leaned on Luke Kepsel a little too much.
That was a good hustle by Grant, though, too, to go get that and save it.
In the paint, Kepsel kick out to Luke. Colt will screen. Ah, a little late on the roll. Luke thought he had him, and Colt never rolled. The runner, Clausen, no. Tipped out. Saved, no. Hinker dives for it. And then gets it loose. Colt Kepsel kicks it back out. Clausen, or Hinker rather, going to kick it out to Clausen and threw it behind him. Right idea, but again, when you leave your feet to pass, things can only bad things can happen usually.
Clausen kind of slid up the three-point line when Hinker did that, and he thought he was still in the corner. Pass sailed out of bounds.
Fast inside, Wilkinson tipped away at last. Ooh, thought it was a double touch. Maybe Luke from behind got it. It was a touch, and it was. Jordan Gow says, no, it's double touched. And that's, again, sometimes you're so close on that baseline call.
Yeah.
You see the guy hit it, it's hard to see that double or that ricochet, but. Again, we've seen this numerous times this weekend. The officials come together and then confer, make the call, right call, move on. That's just, you like to see that.
Yeah, it's awesome.
The team that it goes against doesn't like to see that because then they got to give up the ball, but it's the right thing. Hoyer to Luke Kepsel. Britt Carlson coming out trying to body up Hoyer a little bit, putting his hand on him. That just two guys just bumping and
both the quarterbacks for the football teams.
Come on, you guys are quarterbacks. Quit trying to be so tough.
Yeah.
Kepsel, last second shot off the rim. Howard leads 13-11 after 8 minutes in our opening quarter in our State B Boys Championship game on SDPB.
You've worked hard to build your business, your reputation, your success. Your financial partner should be committed to digging in to drive your vision forward. For 130 years, we've stood by South Dakotans. We've been there, we'll be there. Convenient, connected, committed. Bank West, member FDIC.
A community is more than buildings. It's where you live, where you work. Community is being there for each other. Lending a hand when your neighbors are in need. Community is all of us coming together for a greater purpose. This is community. This is Lloyd.
Oh, Mrs. Blunt, teacher at Dupree right there on camera. Very nice. Well done, guys. That's probably extra credit for making sure that she gets on camera. So well done. Our camera guys again, Kingsley Parker, Brandon Eagle Chasing, Talon Lee, Jeremiah Tiger. Thanks, guys. Good work all weekend long. Been fun having you guys here. Caden Fast on ball. George Jensen back in with those two fouls. Van Regenmoor to three from the left wing. Got it. Trace steps up with a triple. He doesn't look to score a ton.
He said X factor at the beginning. Normally that's with his defense and rebounding, but he's known to hit those once in a while.
They may need him to score a couple of buckets, especially with Jensen having to go in and out probably for a while here with that foul trouble.
Yeah.
In the paint, Colt Kepsel with the left hand that time. Left hand.
You know, one of the things coming out, and DeSmet, obviously three-time state champions, been here, done that. You know the stage isn't too big for them. They've been through it. Howard hasn't been here. These kids haven't been here. How are they going to handle this atmosphere? So far, so good. It's one of those things we talked about. DeSmet just doesn't get rattled.
And Reagan Mortar. Missed the rebound, Wilkinson, on ball on the run. Nice pass and a finish for on ball. 16-15 to Smith. Howard's had success on the football field over the last few years, so a lot of these guys there seen some of that success. But, yeah, you're right. In this, it's a different atmosphere. You hear it on the football field, not quite like this. There's a foul on Wilkinson, his second. Jensen and Wilkinson now, each with two.
Mentally will come back in for Hinker.
Yeah, we saw Hinker really step up last night when they needed him. He hasn't done a whole lot on offense yet tonight, but again, it's kind of been the Kepsel show here offensively so far. Both Luke and Colt, obviously the only two that scored so far for Howard. Luke on the run, left hand and a foul. Don't travel. The extra step coming through the lane. Kind of lost the handle, but it was after that extra step. And a lot of hands in there. Caden Fast on the wing. Give it up top on ball to Van Regenmoor. Now George Jensen. Down inside. Wilkinson. Good decision. Cool.
Good patience. Good patience by Grant.
Yep.
He knows. Watch the games. He's seen Colt block a lot of shots. He knows.
Yeah, you said Grant Wilkinson is really most improved player from the beginning of the year, obviously, for his team, for sure.
Yeah, without a doubt.
In the paint, Mentally comes away with the loose ball. And Logan is in the right spot at the right time for the finish.
One of those is maybe just missed so badly that the rebound is hard to get. And he just happen to be there and fall in his lap.
Yeah, no one's ready for it. It just falls in between, and he's the small guy in the trees and grabs it. Caden's hit one from that spot, but he didn't do it. Ooh, it's a big screen. And then a bucket by Fast. Caden Fast with his third field goal. He's got 7 points. DeSmit by three. Mentally out top. Now Colt Kepsel looking for Luke on the baseline. Short corner right on the Northern logo. Mentally again on the baseline. Bring it back up. Look back inside. Kepsel with Wilkinson in the paint. Five on the shot clock. Kepsel for three. Got it! Colt Kepsel! 14 in this first half for Colt. Showing his range. Again, I don't know if Colt wants to play or is looking at playing. Man, if he wants to, there's got to be a spot somewhere. Someone's got to want a 6'9 guy, don't they, that can shoot it? I don't know, maybe a month in the weight room, 2 months in the weight room.
Caden Fast again, yeah.
Caden is just, again, so explosive. He reminds me a lot of Sumption, Braden Sumption from Leola Frederick that we've seen. A lot of guys that just mimic each other here. We haven't had our media timeout. This has been a long stretch without a break.
Only one foul this quarter.
Luke Kepsel blocked mentally. Loses the handle. George Jensen comes away with it. Hoyer there to help. Fast steps into a three. No. Rebound taken out of there. On the push out, it's Colby Clausen. Clausen swing it mentally. Up top, Kepsel. He hit the last one. There's another foul. Three on Grant Wilkinson. Has that forearm in the back when a guy's in the air.
That's what I was going to say. Colt goes up to catch it in the air, and that's when Grant kind of moved up under him. And that's, they're going to, you talk about it all the time with the safety.
Well, yeah, that's exactly right. We'll take a break. Our media timeout back in 1 minute. SDPB.
Jackrabbits don't wait to see what the future holds, they build it. At South Dakota State University, the next generation's leaders are preparing to launch. They're focusing on growth, and they're reaching new heights of excellence across vital industries. SDSU is building something greater for South Dakota and the world.
There is a new world out there, revealing itself in unpredictable ways. A world that demands more from the land and those who grow, farm, and build on it. This new world calls for the ingenuity to get more out of it while preserving as much as we can. After all, to stay ahead of tomorrow, we need to be equipped for it today.
Dakota Plains New Holland dealers proudly support high school athletics.
Well, 22-20 to Smith over Howard. 3:07 to play in our second quarter. Ready to inbound from the baseline. Joe Schroeder will put it in play, and we're underway.
Not a ton of points compared to our rest of our games today, but a lot of action. But a well-played first half here.
That's how DeSmit plays, right? I mean, there's always something going on. It's just sometimes it's not always on the offensive end. Long possessions usually. There's a block by Jensen. Gutsy play to go up and block that with two fouls. Grant Wilkinson on the bench with three now. On ball, pull up, no. He saw Kepsel coming at him and kind of stopped the shot.
Yep.
Yeah. Kepsel on the move on the baseline. Gets Jensen in the air. No, yeah, Jensen gonna pick up number three. And George Jensen defensively is just having his struggles with Colt Kepsel. Where do they go? They'll go to the bench and bring in Tristan Olsen.
Tristan, the son of assistant coach Dustin Olsen. Tristan's gained some good minutes this year. I mean, he's a strong, athletic kid. You just lose some size from George and Grant, obviously.
Yeah, 6'1 senior. Losing the handle. Is that Hinker underneath?
Yeah.
It was. And a held ball. It'll go to Howard. Timeout. Tigers.
Yeah, it was a good pass right there from Luke Kepsel, but Hinker just kind of bobbled it and then went up for a reverse layup and just couldn't get it finished.
I wasn't sure if we had a look at that, but yeah, one hand in there. And again, like, it does have one hand. It doesn't have to be two hands, right? One hand to stall it out. I was just going to see if I wasn't sure if I finished my story about Howard St. Agatha. Yeah, so private schools back in the early 60s weren't allowed in the South Dakota High School Activities Association events at that time. And for many years, Howard was the only community to have two championships in 1 year. And again, a lot of that talent had roots in Argonne, which, if you have a little history, back in the 50s was kind of a powerhouse in South Dakota High School. So Argonne, Howard St. Agatha, I mean, just it's crazy, all of the ties across this beautifully small state of ours.
Stories like those when teams make it to a state tournament and you just get to hear about a little bit more of the history,
yeah,
of all the schools that are now maybe a part of that one school district. And back in the day when every town had their own, it was just fun listening to that story with the Blue Goose earlier.
Mm-hmm.
It's that stuff's fun.
Well, and again, Howard, great year this year with the basketball team, and the recent years football. It's been football. Years prior to that, wrestling. They were known as a wrestling town, right? You know, so again, there's just a lot of ties. Wayne Rasmussen played for SDSU in football years and years and years. He's a Howard native. I mean, if you know that. Up and in for Luke Kepsel. 22-22. 1:39 to play.
Obviously a long and storied history for the DeSmet Bulldog program.
Yeah. That will take us too long to get into.
Larry Lugents and Marv McCune. And
the coaching
the
tree,
yeah,
and branches are crazy there. 3-0 good for Fast.
Coach Grunhagen being one of those that played for the legendary Marv McCune,
yeah,
back in the day.
Boy, DeSmet is, you know, they got to be happy, too. They're two big guys, both on the bench with three fouls. Minute to play in the second quarter, and we're tied at 22.
Well, that's one of those things that we talk about, too, right? It's like, okay, it looks like they're on the ropes a little bit, struggling a little bit, some things going against them. And then, that's okay. We're okay. We're just going to defend you harder now.
Yeah.
You guys just aren't going to score for a while.
Severson will send it. Clausen, who gets it into Kepsel. Kepsel, spin move to the middle, up, and a little baby hook. When Kepsel gets to the, he can face up, Luke can face up, Luke can shoot it a little bit, but when he takes it to the block, he is like old school post player right there, isn't he? You know, at 6'4", that was the big guy back in the day. That's what he reminds me of.
Well, and Van Regenmoor, I thought, did a great job of defending him too, just being patient.
Again, we'll catch up with the leading coach right now. Looks like we're going to talk with Nick Kepsel as we head to halftime. If Howard can hold for the final shot, take the lead in with 5-4-3. Luke loses the handle. Rick Carlson will chuck it, but he's standing out of bounds. So 0.2 seconds remaining. All you can get is a tip. You can't catch and shoot here. It's got to be lobbed up and just tip it, or even a catch and shoot in the air isn't possible with 0.2, is it?
No, I don't think so.
I think it's just got to be a simple touch. And they'll say, no, not possible, waving it off.
Had
we'll
it
talk
off before
Nick
the
Kepsel
horn and the light, but, yeah, Jordan Gow came and waved it off.
Jordan! Tried to race. Kepsel's faster than Roush was, so it's gonna. I got to get going over here to catch up with this guy, but we'll catch up with him. Coach Nick Kepsel joins us, and Coach, up 24-22. What a dogfight. Two really good teams going at it right now.
Yeah, no doubt. You got to earn everything you get tonight. Nothing's going to be easy. The refs are letting them play, and that's the way we want it. Finish the half strong there. We got another half to go. We'll see what happens.
You guys have done a really good job getting the ball to Colt Kepsel and to Luke on the block. Got to continue with that?
Yeah, absolutely. That's what we do. We're going to go through those guys. If they don't double them, we're going to ask those guys to go to work and get the job done for us. We'll live and die with those guys.
Appreciate the time. Best of luck second half. Nick Kepsel, head coach. We'll take a break, come back, and give out Spirit of Sioux Award and Spirit of Six next on SDPB.
We hope you're a fan of stories about heroes, because we'd like you to meet a few of ours. These folks keep our communities moving forward. They're dedicated to being here for you, navigating change, keeping you secure, and offering a helping hand to those who need it. Heroes come from many walks. Ours are here to walk with you. Go with trust. Go with people. Go with Dakota Bank.
The most gratifying thing about what I do day in and day out is I get to watch things grow.
When you look at corn and the huge role it plays in feed for our cattle and our, you know, our livestock, our pigs is so huge. Also our ethanol plants.
I sit on South Dakota Corn Growers Association. We're focused on policy. So we work with state representatives as well as our state senators and our representative in Washington.
Sometimes having 15 of something is great, like 15 pizzas. Yo! Nice. But for days of class missed, 15 or more is not so great. The best way for students to own their tomorrow is being present today. See why good habits matter at showupsd.com.
First Dakota is here for the shared community experiences, the competition, long-standing rivalries, the players and coaches, seeing friends again, and cheering on our favorite teams. It's what makes life great here, and First Dakota is here for it.
We're all going somewhere, going higher, faster, farther, going in new directions, to new places. At Monument Health, we keep going so you can keep going. We're dedicated to advanced orthopedic care with the latest innovations, technology, expertise, and treatment. So keep exploring, keep making memories, keep going with Monument Health as your partner. Learn more at monument.health/orthopedics.
From the Barnett Center, let's give away some hardware. Here's Aiden McCafferty. Well, they're going to talk about it. They're going to talk about it real quick here. I thought we were going to Aiden to give away our Spirit of Six, but we may have to wait for the teams to come back out. I thought we gave away the Spirit of Six before the teams come out, but we will see. We may be waiting for them all to come out and then give all the hardware away. While we're waiting, we're going to turn it over to Aiden. He will take it away right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, we direct your attention to the center of the floor for the award that has become known as the Spirit of Six. The Spirit of Six Award was created by the South Dakota Peace Officers Association as a memorial for the six cheerleaders from Rapid City who lost their lives in an airplane accident while returning to Rapid from the 1968 Boys State A basketball tournament. As reported by the Rapid City Journal, the spirit epitomized by the Rapid City cheerleaders was best expressed with an inscription on the picture from one of the Rapid City cheerleaders to another member of the squad. The inscription said, "This year has been quite a challenge for everyone. You've got the qualities that a good cheerleader needs. I sure hope that we go to state basketball because that is definitely one of the better sides of cheerleading. Be happy and enjoy this year with all the memories." The award is based upon the cheerleaders' abilities displayed in the areas of crowd control, sportsmanship, enthusiasm, behavior on and off the court, and dress. This being the 54th year of the South Dakota Peace Officers Association, presenting this award is Bruce Solly from the Peace Officers Association. the 54th anniversary trophy in memory of the six Rapid City cheerleaders goes to the cheerleaders from Howard High School. Of the squad. Members of the squad: Edelyn Halverson, Natalie Martin, Kaylee Schwader, Taylor Reich, Taryn Mentele, Tana Hoyer, Hannah Brown, Paige Mentele, and Coach Audrey Nilges. Your Spirit of Sioux winner, the Howard cheerleading squad.
Congratulations to the Howard High School cheerleaders, the Spirit of Six Award winners. I believe I'm just looking around, six squads here this year, right? Six of eight teams represented with cheerleaders. And again, we'll run the clock down to 3 minutes. The teams will come back out. We'll stop it, and then we'll go to a quick break as soon as they do the Spirit of Sioux winner. And then we'll try to catch up with Coach Kruenhagen in just a moment as well. Teams have not made their way back out. You got a couple of stats in front of you real quick. Let's just give that, save a little time for later.
Yeah, DeSmet shooting 42% from the field. Caden Fast leads them with 9 points. Britt Carlson with 5. Big story for them right now, George Jansen and Grant Wilkinson both with 3 personal fouls. But only down 2, so DeSmet's feeling probably pretty good with where they're at, with as much as their big fellas have had to sit. Howard, meanwhile, shooting 50% from the floor, led by Colt Kepsel's 14 points, Luke Kepsel with 8. Otherwise, stats pretty even. Wynn shows in the score, 24-22. We talked about it coming in. Both teams played great defense. Both teams deliberate on the offensive end, and
coaches are coming back out, and DeSmet's happy with this score as far as keeping it low. Howard's happy with the physicality that's going on out there. As soon as the coaches make their way to their benches or back out, we will award our Spirit of Sioux.
Presentation of the Spirit of Sioux Award. The Spirit of Sioux was created as a memorial for Sue Ann Big Crow. She was best known for her accomplishments on the basketball court, but her academic achievement and community involvement were equally important to her. The Spirit of Sioux Award is given to an outstanding high school athlete participating at this tournament who not only shares Sue Ann's dreams and drive for academic and athletic excellence, but also strives to make life better for others through community service. This player is judged in the categories of outstanding athletic ability, leadership, character, sportsmanship, and GPA. The beautiful colors of the quilt are symbolic of the 4 races of people. Sue Ann had a dream that all races could complement each other and live in harmony, thus making the world as beautiful as the quilt we award tonight. Presenting the award are cousins Emma Hutchinson and Laura Nelson. Federal Order of Police President Ty Renke and Highway Patrolman Tyler Woodside. This year's Spirit of Sioux recipient is from White River High School, Nick Marshall.
Congratulations to Nick Marshall, the Spirit of Sioux Award winner here. Nick from White River High School. The senior finished his career 31-point night tonight in the third place game, and he walks away with some hardware as the Spirit of Sioux Award winner. Take a break, and we'll come back and catch up with Jeff Grunhagen in a moment on SDPB TV.
What does primary care mean to us? At Sanford Health, it means being there when and where you need it most. It means building a relationship, because when a provider really knows you, they can deliver the best care for every aspect of your health and your life. So what does primary care mean for you? It means understanding your health for today and for where you're headed next. It means a lifetime of care for a lifetime of you.
Oh my goodness.
We're trying to promote the Descendants of Doom tour, you know, trying to make everybody look kind of metal and, you know.
Menacing, menacing.
The band just got covered by Delta Dental, so they kind of can't stop smiling.
They need to look more metal, and they don't look metal. What do we do?
Pop off a few more, see what we get.
Give me some metal.
All right, yeah. 3, 2, 1.
Delta Dental!
The word cooperative means working together for a common purpose. At Actegra Cooperative, we are dedicated to supporting the success of our farmers and the health of our communities for generations to come. Rooted in our communities, Actegra strives to instill dedication, determination, and integrity in everything we do, and that includes inspiring the next generation of agricultural leaders.
Back at the Barnett Center, head coach Jeff Grunhagen of the DeSmet Bulldogs joins us. Coach, another tight battle, 24-22, low scoring. You guys like that low scoring kind of game. Maybe want to be ahead.
It's all right, but we're not in the, you know, we've been too much fouling, you know, getting there a little bit late. We got to work on getting better defense, getting position early, and get back and attack a little offensively.
Are you happy with your offensive possessions, or just got to get to the rim a little better?
They've made, you know, Kepsel's got a couple blocks on us. I think we got to be, you know, more confident, willing to shoot open shots. We passed up some open ones. We got to take some little better ones and keep working it, I think.
Appreciate the time. Best of luck.
Thanks.
Appreciate it. Jeff Grunhagen, he says, hey, we just got to take our time, get better shots, and not foul so much, Steve.
Yeah, you knew he was going to be happy with the defensive effort and other than the fouls, but look for them to get Tommy Ombaugh going a little bit, maybe Britt Carlson, knock those down, and then continue to pound it inside if George Jensen and Grant Wilkinson can stay on the floor and stay out of foul trouble the second half.
Well, you suppose the Howard Faith will be a little extra amped up to start the second half with their cheerleaders winning the Spirit of Six. They got the lead at halftime of the state championship, and, you know, they're playing pretty well.
Yeah, and, you know, if you're Howard, you got to feel good with where you're at. You got to feel like Coach Kepsel, you think you played a pretty good half of basketball, and right there, two-point lead in the state championship game in the second half. If you told Nick that at the beginning of the season, I think he's probably signing up for it. The same with Coach Grunhagen. He's been there, done that. I fully expect this to be a battle till the very end.
Well, you know, and DeSmet's just got, they have an expectation that's at a different rate right now because they expect higher things just because they've been here. But at the same time, winning's hard, right? I mean, it ain't easy to come out every night and get wins.
Yeah, without a doubt. And they know. They know how to do it. They're not going to panic.
Nope. That one gets away from them there on a errant pass. Hoyer, nice dish into Kepsel. Kepsel blocked by Jensen. Kepsel gets it back up over George and gets it to roll in. Colt does a nice job slowing down, too. You talk about Grant being patient. Grant Wilkinson on the other side. That time, Colt Kepsel gets blocked, gets it back, and then slows down to finish.
When you saw George Jensen got a piece of that first one, great block. Again, he's just one of those kids that explodes and jumps real quick.
Jensen for three. George sat a long time with foul trouble.
He kind of had to let that second one go when Colt got that rebound. But there he is on the offensive end, and that's what George gives him. kid that can not only score it down low, but another shooter to help spread the floor a little bit. The Smith, a little 2-3 zone.
Wait,
right
what?
Now. Yeah.
What? Who? Somebody's sick over there, right? What in the world? 26-25.
They did play some 1-3-1 this year. Gave us fits when we played them, but that was just a straight 2-3.
Caden Fast, a little strong on the jumper. And then Kepsel has it taken away on the bounce pass. Fast will run out, lay it up and in. And a lead for the Bulldogs, 27-26. Just like you said, they don't get rattled. First possession down two, they throw it away. They come right back, now they're up one.
Well, they don't let one mistake turn into two or three. Or if they do, they just got that uncanny ability to just lock in defensively even more than they normally are.
Nice bounce pass. Ben Regenmore, the recipient, up and in. And a timeout, 30-second timeout. Nick Kepsel and the Howard Tigers. Little flat. Howard came out, I think, just a little flat. The bounce wasn't as much, and a couple of errant passes, giving it back to DeSmit.
Well, it goes back to what we kind of talked about at the beginning, is are they feeling a little bit of the pressure now? You know,
right.
And we talked about it, and it's, you can't overstate it enough. Being here as many times in a row as DeSmit has and being in this atmosphere, it's intimidating at times, and they know how to play through that.
.539 to play in the third quarter. Usually it's the student section only that's on their feet. The Smith and Howard adult sections have sat down.
They're just, across from us on the whole side, yep.
Section N and Section L, for the most part, about 90% all standing up. Section M in the middle, they got to stand up once in a while just to see either end of the court. Bentley will bring it to Kepsel. Kepsel swinging around on the baseline. Hoyer. And that'll be thrown out. Fast will outrace everybody and go get it and lay it in. No foul. Logan Bentley will pick up his first. Caden Fast will go to the free throw line. Boy, he showed how quick he can be, didn't he?
Great kid, great athlete.
I mean, let's be honest, he was born fast.
that's right.
First free throw is good.
Fast family was Iroquois. His uncle Jesse actually played for Iroquois in the 99 state tournament and was the Spirit of Sioux winner, but very similar. Jesse wasn't quite as tall as him, but just as quick as anybody you've seen.
4-point lead for the Bulldogs, 30-26. Somebody said earlier, first one to 40 win this game. We'll find out. As much as both teams have slowed down and not scored, they can score quickly. Nice little jumper by Colby Clausen across the lane. Shout out to Sioux Falls, one of my students when I student taught at Howard, Jenny Sherman, now Jenny Broomsma, watching in. So Jenny, thanks for having it on. Good to hear from you. Baseline, Britt Carlson, way out high. Caden Fast to George Jensen, guarded by Luke Kepsel. Van Regenmoor trying to pull Kepsel out. Now he'll shoot it. Another bucket by Van Regenmoor.
Just didn't quite like where he was at. Had to slide over a little bit.
Well, I think you want to see if Colt would really come out and guard him. .33-28. Now it's a matter of Howard at least getting buckets back at their end to keep it from getting away from him. Mentally, three, that's the answer. Logan knocks down the triple. Five in the game for Logan Bentley.
you talked to Coach Kepsel about it at halftime, about Colt and Luke and continuing to play through them, but they're going to need some of the other guys, and you saw Mentley step up and hit one. Van Regenmorter's done it for the Bulldogs, and it's kind of those other guys, other than the main, your leading scorers, stepping up and providing a little bit.
Again, a different look. You prepare. You're going to play DeSmit in the state tournament. What do you prepare for? As we'll talk about when we come back from the media timeouts. It's already 3:20 left in the third. We're back with more on SDPB.
We all need insurance to protect our health, our homes, our belongings, and our businesses. But coverage is just the beginning. You also need the support of professionals who stand by your side to protect what's important to you. Fisher Rounds and Associates combines the coverage you want with the commitment you need. Fisher Rounds and Associates, at your service, at your side.
Powering the possibilities of tomorrow starts today. For our homes, our farms, our businesses. That's why our Touchstone Energy Cooperative continually plans for the future by utilizing and sourcing safe, reliable power for the next generation. So we can power possibilities long into the future. Touchstone Energy Cooperatives, powering possibilities.
Out of the media timeout, the Smet will make their way out. And I totally forgot my train of thought, what we were talking about as we went to break. I'm still surprised that we were going in. I know I had some story to tell you. 33-31, the Smet leading Howard.
We're talking about them coming out on a zone.
Oh, yeah, the 2-3 zone.
The one thing you don't.
Yeah, you prepare to play against what? Man-to-man, right? Now here they come in a 2-3, just a little wiggle, and all of a sudden slows you down on offense. Clausen for three. You said it. Who's going to step up? Mentley hit one. Clausen's now hit one. They got to loosen it up to let the big guys get going again.
Yeah, part of going to that zone, I think, is to be able to kind of contain the two Kepsels and kind of know where they're at with what they're doing, and that's leaving other guys open.
Foul on Britt Carlson from the backside. Britt picks up his second personal.
Like Grant Wilkinson getting ready to check back in here for DeSmet.
He'll come in with those three fouls. George has played through this quarter without picking up a fourth. But that zone helps with that. And in the corner, Mentley with the three. Wow, Logan's got six in the quarter, eight in the game. And now it's a Howard 4-point lead. Fast misses the reverse layup.
Good attack by Caden. Just had to come to the opposite side of the hoop to.
Capsule lays it in over the front of the rim. I thought we were going to see dunk number seven for a second. And a timeout, Bulldogs. Howard faithful on their feet, making some noise. 1:56 to play in our third quarter. A reminder, SDPB connects South Dakotans through our statewide network. We're able to bring you boys basketball coverage because of support from viewers just like you. Become a member now and your gift will be matched. Donate online at sdpb.org. Call 1-800-777-0789. Or scan that QR code right now on your screen and then click the donate button. Support SDPB programs, sdpb.org. Because of your help, we get to bring you excitement like this at what is sometimes feels like a whole nother level, doesn't it?
Yeah, this has been fun. I mean, I've enjoyed every minute of this and being able to see it from here, and you talked about it too. Front row seat for these 12 games has been fun.
Yeah, we appreciate you coming along. You had a lot of insight being a guy that's been through big games as a coach and fun. Boys basketball coach. Boys and girls coach differently sometimes.
Yeah. And being in here, it's been a while. 2009 since we were here, and same vibe.
Yeah.
It doesn't change. The teams change, but the atmosphere and what Aberdeen does for this is second to none.
Pretty incredible. Van Regenmorter at the free throw line. Swing it. Big Grant Wilkinson away out at the left wing. We're trying to get George Jensen one-on-one, but Howard and Colt Kepsel doing a good job. Saying, go ahead, stand out there with it.
Yeah.
I don't have to work so hard. Rebound, Colt Kepsel. Grant Wilkinson just about got a big paw on that to take it away.
Thought Nick or Luke was going to pull that one.
Colt Kepsel, swing it out top.
To Smet, back to man-to-man.
Yeah, I'm impressed with Howard's maturity also, especially in a moment like this where they haven't been in this situation.
No. They've played all tournament long, like they've been to four or five straight.
Yeah. Is that block? No, they'll just say last touch by Kepsel. He lost the handle going up. It got stripped, and then he tried to hit it down to Luke Kepsel and just hit it out of bounds.
Yeah, just good defense there by Smet again, and Luke loses control and out of bounds.
Tom on ball with under a minute to play here in the quarter. Howard wishes it was first to 40 because they're only 1 point away when we mentioned that earlier. Jensen will have it stripped. Wow. Right now, Logan Mentley has just stepped up big time for this Howard Tiger team. Howard hoping for a dead ball to get some subs and steal an extra minute, but may not get that. Luke Kepsel through the hands of Colt Kepsel, taken away by Van Regenmorter on the loose ball, gets it back to Caden Fast, swinging around. On ball to Grant Wilkinson. And then last touch by Howard out of bounds. So the subs will come in. Hoyer, Severson, and Meyer for, was it Meyer in for Howard. Kepsel, Mentley, Colt Kepsel, Mentley, and then Clausen gonna get a little extra break here. Steal that extra 60 seconds and a lob into Fast. Down to 10 on the clock. Crossover to the lane. Fast draws the contact from Taden Hoyer. Taden with his first foul.
Yeah, it's a good job by Caden coming to his left, and Taden just kind of crowding him a little bit and goes up and through the contact.
Caden Fast with the free throw up and good.
Caden's been solid all tournament too. You know, and we've talked about it too. You look at DeSmith's leading scorers for the tournament, and they've scored a lot.
But no.
Then you go back and look at their scores. They've scored 41 and 40 as a team. So the 8 or 10 that 10 or 12 that George Jensen and Caden Fass have scored each of the games.
We'll call
it's a big
carry.
Percentage.
Yeah, yeah. For sure. Well, it was as big as a six-point lead for Howard after they fell behind to open this quarter. Is that four right now? And DeSmet will have a chance to close it to two or even one with a three. Jensen, couple dribbles, two, one, step back three. No, is he on the line?
No, I was just going to say we've seen this before, right?
We go to our final 8 minutes. The Howard Tigers lead 39-35. We're back with more on SDPB.
Bioethanol supplies more than just energy. It creates jobs in rural communities. It drives demand for local corn. It provides opportunities for family farms to thrive. To ensure agriculture plays a leading role in the efforts to decarbonize and transition energy, bioethanol remains at the forefront of a pursuit for a cleaner, brighter future for all Americans. Learn how at sdethanol.com.
The word cooperative means working together for a common purpose. At Actegra Cooperative, we are dedicated to supporting the success of our farmers and the health of our communities for generations to come. Rooted in our communities, Actegra strives to instill dedication, determination, and integrity in everything we do, and that includes inspiring the next generation of agricultural leaders.
We're just about ready for our final 8 minutes in Aberdeen. Shout out to AZ down in Arizona. Jeff Quincy listening in, watching in, I should say.
The Q Dog.
Yeah, the Q Dog. Former Dolphin.
Yep.
We're good to go.
Former roommate in college.
Is it really?
Yep.
Wow, you're a lucky guy. Yeah,
right, I know. Some would say.
That's right. We're underway in our final quarter. Baseline. Kepsel just about lost his footing. Luke to the lane, kick out. Clausen for three. Got it! Colby Clausen. Another three. He's got eight in the second half, eight for the game. It's amazing what happens in big time moments, isn't it?
Yeah, it's just fun to see kids step up and make those types of plays.
Caden Fast down the lane, kick out all the way out to Van Regemorter. Speaking of which, Trace with the triple.
Right on cue.
George Kiner used to sing a song called Anything You Can Do, I Can Do Better. I can do anything better than you. They match it. Three at one end, three at the other. He's a way better singer than me, by the way. Yeah. Just thought I'd say that. Colby Clausen. Down the lane. Spin move. Block, but a foul. Van Regemorter didn't like it, but he's just, oh, he was so close. Good defense right up until there. Arm to arm. Hand on the ball, but again, forearm to forearm, still contact, right? I mean, when you reach across like that, it's just so hard to get away with that block. Great effort, though, by Trace Van Regemorter. I don't think he's come out of the game yet, has he?
I do not believe so. Just got one foul, but with Jensen and Wilkinson picking up those earlies, they couldn't afford to take Trace off.
Funny how we talked about at halftime with Coach Kepsel getting the ball back into Luke and Colt, getting them touches. They got 6 points in the second half between them. 3, 6, 9, 12, 14 from others.
There's Van Regemorter again, saving a possession.
And Carlson hits the three. Britt Carlson has 8 points. Courtesy the kick out on the offensive glass from Trace Van Regemorter. Got a timeout. Dismit one in the 5 second, but they count a lot faster when they know that it's almost a turnover. 30 second, or they go 60? Must have went 60. Everybody's having a seat. Just a reminder, In Play with Craig Maddock features in-depth discussions about all things sports in South Dakota. Through these conversations, we learn about the players, programs, and legends who help shape the current sports landscape of the Mount Rushmore State. You can find the podcast on Apple, Google, Spotify, and wherever you get your podcasts. Be sure to leave us a 5-star review so that others are able to find it. In Play with Craig Maddock. Listen now wherever you get your podcasts. Are you a big podcast listener?
I don't, not a lot, no.
I catch myself doing it every so often. I probably catch up with Craig's more so on the posts on social media, other places, rather than the actual podcast. But, yeah, a lot of great stuff out there. 6:10 to play. Coach Kepsel, a little drink of water. His daughter, Kennedy, right behind him, one of the assistant coaches on the bench, Ryan Spader. See him in the background. There's Coach Grunhagen, Coach Olson. They are battling it out here, a Highway 25 battle.
It's been a good one.
Way out high, Luke Kepsel, 15 on the shot clock now after that timeout. Hinker, he's been quiet tonight, but won't be surprised if he gets into it. The dish. The dive, the finish on cue, Carson Hinker. Again, courtesy of the big man, Colt Kepsel averages almost 4 assists per game. You got to be a good passer when you get double teamed, right? Oh,
yeah,
just about for on ball. So close.
And Tommy just hasn't been able to wiggle loose to get any room to get shots off.
Well, and again, tonight it's Colby Clawson who drew the defensive assignment. And it's just been not total denial, but you really just don't give any help, you know? And
yeah. Just not worried about the other parts of your man defensive right. principles. It's like, don't lose track of him.
Here's the thing. You go through preseason in the middle of the season, you just dig in. You work man-to-man, man-to-man. We're going to work our fundamentals. You got to be help side. You got to hand in the lane. And then you get here, and you're like, don't help anybody. Don't leave that guy. Just stay out there with him. 46-43. Howard by 3. They've led by as many as 6. That's been the biggest lead either way. D. Smith trying to amp up the defense just a little bit as they go back to man-to-man. Kepsel one-on-one with Jensen in the paint. Kick out. Mentley thought about it. Now he'll drive and shoot. Can't get it to go. So out of the 2-3 and back into man-to-man for DeSmit.
Yeah, when they came back to man too, you can just see just a little more sense of urgency and getting up into it a little bit more.
Well, we're under 5 minutes to play now in our final quarter of the state championship. 3 in the corner, Carlson in and out, no good. Rebound by Van Riggemorter. Foul going to be called on Colt Kepsel. Just Colt second. Not going to hurt anything necessarily as it's the second team fouling again in a close game. Might need him later.
Yeah. Great job by Van Riggemorter going to get it.
4:38 to play. Media timeout. We're back with more on SDPB.
Jackrabbits don't wait to see what the future holds. They build it. At South Dakota State University, the next generation's leaders are preparing to launch. They're focusing on growth, and they're reaching new heights of excellence across vital industries. SDSU is building something greater for South Dakota and the world.
What does primary care mean to us? At Sanford Health, it means being there when and where you need it most. It means building a relationship, because when a provider really knows you, they can deliver the best care for every aspect of your health and your life. So what does primary care mean for you? It means understanding your health for today and for where you're headed next. It means a lifetime of care for a lifetime of you.
Good to go out of the timeout with 4:38 to play. What, 2 timeouts for Howard, 4 timeouts for D. Smith, 3-point game. 3-point basket, time on ball.
God, if you remember back to last year, this same environment, same place. I don't think he missed a shot.
Shooter shoot, right?
Yep, big game Tommy.
Hoyer. Wasn't sure if he wanted to dribble it or not. Finally gets rid of it. Hinker way out high with 15 to Kepsel. Kepsel. Fake the pass. Take his time in the paint. Partially blocked. Collision.
Great defense in the post that time by Jensen. Just kind of walling up and making it a tough look.
Howard doing every, or rather, DeSmit doing everything they needed to do when down 6 to hang in there, and now have tied it up. Jensen just about lost it. There's what happens when you don't watch the ball, right?
Yeah.
Clawson doing what you're supposed to, not letting Tom have the ball on ball on the outside, but steal bounces off the back of his head. Clawson will give it up. Hinker now. Kepsel out high. Kepsel down the lane, loses it. Colt Kepsel picks it up to the basket. Too strong. Didn't quite get squared up. First half, those were going in.
Yep. Jensen took one to the...
and the chin?
Nose or chin or something there.
Van Riggemorter looking for on ball, can't get it there. Fast, looking for a screen, asking Trace spin, right? No, he'll get one from George. Tough wow, shot, Caden yeah. Fast. Up and in with the left hand. And DeSmit leads by two. 48-46 with 2:48 to play and a timeout, Bulldogs.
Great play by Caden Fast right there to attack and go to the left hand for the finish. There's a senior who's wants to go out on top.
Yeah, he was huge last year as a part of this group that won a state title, played a little bit as a sophomore in that state title run, playing behind guys like Kalen Gary. I saw guys like Red Ostis and those guys play. Just incredible to continue that tradition for the Bulldogs.
Yeah, it's this whole group kind of, you know, it's, you mentioned that to Coach Greenhagen last night, and he said that this group's played together for a long time, obviously being mostly seniors, and you can tell that. You can just tell they're comfortable with each other and trust one another to be where they're supposed to be and make the plays they're supposed to make.
Yeah, through the years, you know, just the names that pop out from DeSmit when you talk about Ostis and you talk about McNames, you talk about the Hines, you talk about Cruz, you talk about Marshall, and the list just goes on and on. Rob Schmidt, Mark Schultz, all those. I mean, it's constant.
Yep.
It's amazing how some communities just have that. You know, they live and breathe it,
yep.
And that's what it's like in DeSmit. On the wing, Luke Kepsel, one-on-one with Ben Regemorter. To his right hand, off the glass, and good. Wow, 6'4 junior, just good. Calm, cool, and collected.
Well, and really good play because Trace did a great job defensively of sitting on Luke's right shoulder so he'd come back to his left hand, and Luke noticed that and just goes to his right.
I mean, we've been here long enough this week, right? Like, we might as well stay a little while long. Let's play overtime. What do you think?
It's been a good one. We might as well. The way we're going, it might be.
I sat right across the way from here and called a 3 overtime game in this gym, and that was one of those classics, so I'd love to be a part of it again. On the baseline, Kepsel. Hoyer down the lane. Hoyer spin in traffic. Lost the handle. Got too deep. Didn't know where he was at, right in front of the rim. Tied at 48 with 95 seconds to play. They're going to go double post at the elbows. On ball. Little shimmy. They all wanted to travel, but I don't know if he ever picked up either foot. He just kind of shook back and forth.
Look over at the DeSmit crowd. Trace thought about pulling that one. And
now he will. Blocked! Kepsel blocks the three-point shot. 3 seconds on the shot clock. 109 to play in the quarter.
It's one of those little Trace almost had to shoot it just because of where the shot clock was at.
Jensen to the corner. They'll try to go there. Can't. Just got to throw it in up top. Caden Fast. That's a foul. Nope. Yeah. Hoyer just leaning on top of Fast that whole time. And ended up being on the shot. Probably could have called it on the drive earlier as well.
Yeah. Caden had one of those kind of exact plays coming to his left earlier and on Hoyer, too.
Fast with the free throw.
He's been pretty solid at the line. Remember in the Gregory game, he got that steal and 2 free throws to tie that game before the Jensen heroics.
5 out of 6. On the night. Bigger, though, as a 2-point lead for his team. Hoyer right in front of us to Colt Kepsel, now into Luke Kepsel. Luke, spin move, left hand, oh, fouled and can't get it to go. Really good fake, got Van Regemorter off his feet. I've been impressed with Trace Van Regemorter this week. This 3 days, what a great tournament he's had.
Yeah.
Just plays under control. I mean, there, yeah, you get faked out, but that's a good offensive move.
And we talked about it, and he's one of those, you mentioned last night with, like, Lowy. You don't see a whole lot of emotion out of Trace. I mean, it's like that. Fouled you. Let's next play and let's go.
The one time where he thought maybe he had the block, he got a little excited. But again, then he just handed the ball off. Yeah. And, you know, just really respectful. Fun kid to watch play the game as hard as he plays it. Under a minute to go. There's a few people still sitting down on the ends, at least, and behind us. But across the way, not so much. Fast on the left wing. Out top, Carlson. 16 seconds difference, shot clock to game clock. On ball, the floater, no. Rebound, Hinker. 25 seconds to play. Do they take timeout and draw it up? Down to 19-18.
Wow. Here we go. Everybody yes. on their
14
feet.
14 seconds and a timeout. You knew it was coming.
I thought maybe he was going to let him play it out.
You know, tie game, but you want to make sure that they don't throw something away either. So you want to make sure everybody knows we want to go late. It's one shot to win it, or we're playing four more minutes. I mean, that's what it comes down to, right?
You asked for it, so yeah.
Yeah, well, nobody usually gives me what I ask for, so.
One timeout left for the Tigers, three for DeSmit.
Alternating possession arrow, DeSmit basketball. Neither team in the two shot. So fouls to give if you're DeSmit.
Son, that's DeSmit. You don't let him get a you don't let him get a clean look off for sure.
You could foul two
just
times
not,
and
just
run.
Just not on the shot, obviously, but yeah.
Yeah, run 3-4 seconds off. Make them take one more timeout. I mean, who knows? It's just you can play it a lot of ways.
Burn that last one, but yeah, who knows? I mean, this has been a whale of a game though.
Over 6,500 unique devices watching in tonight. We thank each and every one of you that are watching somewhere. I understand here in town there's a few eating establishments, restaurants that have the big screens on all the different games going on with college, but they're playing us.
Guess what? They, really they even hear. Turned the volume on for us.
That's
what I heard.
It only takes once. We hope you guys are enjoying these games as much as we have. Yeah. I know that. What an honor to be able to sit here and call these games for you.
For sure.
Howard to inbound. Luke Kepsel comes to get it and a foul. Yep,
there it is.
Ben Regenmorter uses it right away. His second. And again, good decision. 2 seconds come off the clock. Right? You know, again, you take it down. Howard doesn't want to shoot it till there's about 4 or 3 seconds left anyway, right? Because you don't want to take a chance of giving them anything to set up.
And that's,
what's your
and that's
play?
Too, that's too, you know, you don't want to shoot it at the buzzer either because you want a chance if you don't make it, especially with a kid like Kepsel out there to go maybe get an offensive board and a putback too. So not too late, not too early.
Now Kepsel, they're going to play it out. Foul again. There it comes. It's almost like we've thought about doing this before.
Yeah.
Now you play it out. 6.7. You don't have as much time to set up your play. Look for Luke Kepsel and Colt Kepsel both to get chances at touches right here. Timeout.
Yep, there's Howard's last. I was going to say, remember they got one timeout left, and now they were on the opposite side of the court, so was it the same play, or do we need to talk about it? And Coach Kepsel says, let's visit.
Good decision. It's a 30-second timeout, so everybody will stand, circle up on their coaches.
And I really like that idea, what Coach Grunhagen just did of burning some of that time. But also in that same token, now you're at 4, so if you get something called out front,
now you put them at the line.
Now they're at the line.
I like the first one especially.
Yeah.
And you maybe could even wait it because Howard was not in a hurry.
And I think Howard maybe thought that too, like, hey, they're going to come foul us again. Maybe they burned enough time.
Right.
Out there on their own, but
again, for those of you that are just casual basketball fans, seriously, those are the crazy things that go through coaches' minds, right? What do we do in this situation? Should we use it? Should we not use it? Split second decisions.
Yeah. And there's a reason DeSmit's been here 5 times and won 3 in a row. He knows what he's doing.
Now, if you're Howard, you don't want to throw it toward the other end.
No.
You got to keep it toward your basket. Because then if it is taken up or taken away, you force.
Yep, kind of a tough place to inbound.
Kepsel with 6, 5, 4, Luke Kempsel lean in, got it! 1.4 seconds to play. They're gonna put some time on the clock.
It'll be a little bit back.
And
on.
Luke Kempsel, what a move!
That was Trace Van Regenmoor. I don't know if you can defend that much better than he just did, but the patience Luke showed, kind of the step through, the pivot, extra step, and didn't drag it.
And then took it up and under.
Yeah.
What a, I mean, just a great move. They're gonna talk this over. We may have a little time added. I wasn't watching there, and I don't know if you can see the clock. Again,
when I looked,
1.2, there we go. I was saying 1.4, but they go to 1.2 on the clock. 52-50, they haven't put the score on the clock yet. They haven't put the score on the board, but it should be 52-50. Now it's up there. Wow.
Again, DeSmit's got timeouts left. I don't know if you got a ton of time to throw it down here and take another timeout quick, but then you're not leaving much left for a shot on this end.
Yeah, you can't foul either. Well, you can. Howard's only got
Howard
three fouls. That's right. Horn went off before he threw it. Yeah. They got to wait, right? I mean, officials handed that in before the horn goes off.
That was the horn for the end of the timeout.
Right.
It wasn't the play clock or anything like that.
It's the timeout clock. You have to give. You've got to let that time run out. So now you just go reset it. Full timeout. And I don't think you worry about the alternating possession arrow. You know what DeSmit has to do, right? You got to throw it the length or three quarters like we just saw. So we saw this earlier today. Does Howard put Colt Kempsel over the ball, make him have to throw it high with the giant scoreboard in the middle? That changes things,
that,
right?
Or do you put Kempsel down here and
to
contest
try to knock
a
it
shot?
Away.
Or yeah,
you don't
want to
foul
away.
Either.
Well,
on a shot.
They can.
On a
yeah,
shot,
not a
though.
Shot. Yeah, very good.
And you know it's going to be a quick shot, right? You got to catch and shoot.
Depending on where you catch it, you got maybe a one dribble with a, you know.
You'll see sometimes a throw to half court, a catch, a timeout.
Yep.
And now you got a chance to do it again.
And they do have one left to do that, but you do that, and then you're looking at under a second. Then it is a catch and a shoot in the half court, but it just kind of depends on what you have.
There they do. They're going to double up George Jensen. Carlson, the quarterback, will chuck it. Jensen. He did it again! He did it again! It's a two! Unbelievable! George Jensen.
And that was, that was clearly off from the looks of that.
And they'll look at it. They'll come to the replay to make sure. They'll spin it around. It was a two, though, right? He was well inside the three-point line.
Yeah,
okay.
He was 15 foot
here.
Here
it is. Here. Oh, no, that's just the earlier three.
We don't want to look at that.
That wasn't it. That had nothing to do with it. That was way earlier.
Here it is.
Right there. From just inside the elbow, 0.3. Yep, it's plenty away, 0.2 seconds. We're going overtime, my friend.
Wowza.
We'll keep it here. Basket's good. 0.2 seconds as it went in, and we put 4 minutes up. Wow.
Each team will get an additional timeout. Four
that
minutes.
Yeah, unbelievable. I was watching Trace Van Regenmoor come out of the timeout there, and he was kind of tugging on his jersey, almost like he was upset with himself that Luke Kempsel made that great move on him and scored. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I was just going to say, dude can't hang his head because what an effort.
And
George Jensen again.
I don't know, Trace not feeling well or something because he's not in right now either. So maybe something happened.
That or just a little bit overheated in
yeah.
situation. Like he hasn't been off the floor yet.
Oh, yeah, exactly. He's logged a lot of minutes, and he's had a tough challenge guarding Luke Kempsel and sometimes Colt, too. So,
Lordy.
George Jensen, one of those kids, too, though.
On ball.
Twice this tournament.
Yeah.
And just one, goes about his business.
One for the winner, one to put it into overtime. How many kids dream of situations like that?
That's
I mean,
you're in your backyard. in the driveway, and that you're counting down. State tournament, right? State B's at the Barnett Center. Not sure about banking them in, but.
But they'll take it.
Yeah, they went in.
DeSmit will handle out of the jump ball. On ball for three. No, too strong. Rebound. Ripped out of there by Hoyer as Wilkinson just about brought it in. Luke Kepsel now. Again, no media timeouts. And a foul. Oh, player control foul. I didn't see the man on the bottom.
Caden Fast.
Yeah, here you'll see it. He got by Wilkinson. And yeah, good job. He was over there quick and just waited. So the foul on Luke Kepsel, his second personal. No foul trouble whatsoever for Howard.
And
really not for DeSmit. No. Three on Jensen, three on Wilkinson.
Which they had in the beginning of the second quarter.
They both sat a long time. It was a high scoring game for this team, 52-52. Kepsel with the block. You know, back to that basket by Jensen, almost more impressive is the catch from behind Kepsel. They put Colt Kepsel in front, and he just about tipped it. Jensen was able to catch, step, and shoot.
And then you had
Christian Laettner.
And then he had 6'4 Luke Kepsel to shoot it over, too.
Yeah. Wilkinson. Back out top. Jensen for three. No. Rebound. Howard.
Wow. Not many people in the bleachers on either of the three sides that are sitting down.
Britt Carlson trying to get out a little too tight. Was that the fourth foul, though?
Well, that should be five.
That would be five, right? Yeah, they used them both up. So Carlson picks up his third, and we go to the free throw line with Tayden Hoyer. Hoyer has not scored tonight. Why not now, right?
Yeah.
Makes the first free throw to get his team the lead in overtime.
He's done a good job defensively chasing Caden Fast around, which is not an easy task.
Yeah, Hoyer rolls that one in. In overtime, 54-52, Howard with 2:21 to play. On ball, picks up the dribble and has to go to Carlson. Fast will come get it. Jumper. No good. Rebound. Hinker.
Just can't get it to fall.
No hurry if you're the Tigers. Really not if you're DeSmit either. Plenty of time with shot clock. You got a lot of possessions left in this game.
Still no Trace Van Regenmorter. That's...
Yeah, it's interesting.
I hope everything's all right with Trace.
Loose ball. Carlson comes up with it.
Just hustle play.
Timeout to Smet.
Both of them. Colby Clausen, right, and Caden Fast.
I'll tell you what. You got to give credit, too, to Joe Schroeder, Jordan Gow, Darren Lorenz. They've refereed a really good Chase State Championship game right here. I mean, we've seen games throughout tournaments where both crowds kind of get anxious about stuff. One or two times I remember where kind of people jumped it a little bit. Yeah. Other than that, that's a pretty darn good night.
Yeah. And I think all tournament long.
Yeah.
Really. I mean, it's been a great group. Like you said, we got to visit with them last night. And
I know people will say, if it's a foul in the first, it's a foul in the fourth. And you're right. It is. You're right. But at the same time, there's a fine line where you got to let players play it out when it isn't gaining an advantage like that. That could have been called a foul during the regular season, right?
And there's not a single one of those three that want to decide this game. They want it to be decided by the 10 kids on the floor.
Yeah, and they are part of an instant classic as well. So fun to watch. On ball to Fast. Now Jensen in the lane. Carlson. Britt's had a pretty good night, too, with a couple big buckets. 15 on the shot clock. Carlson for three. Got it. On the baseline, Britt Carlson.
to Smet up one. 1 minute left.
Colt Kepsel, oh, so close to dropping that one in. He'll go to the free throw line instead. Pretty good move down inside by the big guy. Again, to be able to play as hard and as long as these guys have played, still make those quick moves.
Wow.
Oh, he's got sweet touch, right? I mean,
here comes Van Regenmorter.
Kepsel with the sweet touch. Be interesting, does that 3 minutes that he got to sit there, you know, of game time, so five and a half, 6 minutes of real time, does that get him fresh for one more minute? Kepsel splashes the second one. That first one was the big one. But it's a one-point Howard lead now. Similar to the end of regulation with under a minute to go on the time on the shot clock to game clock. Fast, left it short, rebound. Luke Kepsel and the Tigers with one timeout and a one-point lead. Just about rolled his ankle. I don't know.
I think the pivot stayed.
The right foot was the pivot foot. Yep. That didn't move. It looked funny.
Funny about rolled an ankle and went down.
Yeah, it looked funny. And a foul. Got extended a little bit here, so I suppose you want possessions.
I mean, you could have let it go 17. It would have gave you 9, but, yeah, you don't know what. One timeout left for each team.
Carson Hinker, 2 points in the game. That was a field goal in the fourth quarter. Chance to go to the free throw line and put his team up 3. First one's too strong. Could see that just a little anxious. Possession arrow this time favoring Howard, however. Second one, no good. Kepsel with the rebound. And Colt is fouled.
Man, if Colt could have just turned around, there was nobody behind him. Everybody was on this side.
Well, and again, he knows they're ahead, so he's looking to get it out. Foul called on number 23, Britt Carlson, I think.
And if you're DeSmet, that's what you got to do right away, right? Just go for that steal, and if you foul.
Yep.
No worse for the wear because you're still only down one right now.
Kepsel back to the free throw line again. This one's on the way and good. I will guarantee you that as a boy growing up with the two older sisters that he had, they spent a lot of time in the driveway doing free throw contests or playing 21, and mom and dad probably out there too. Colt. 7 for 7 at the free throw line is Colt Kepsel. 3-point game, the takeaway by Kepsel. He wants him, come foul me. And there it is. The foul with Kepsel going back to the free throw line. A chance to just about ice it.
Onbaugh tried to penetrate and felt like he got bumped out of bounds. It was tough to see from here.
Two free throws could be the dagger, right? We'll see. He wanted me to say that earlier.
Who was it?
I think it was Talon that wanted me to say that.
Okay, yeah.
I don't know, there's some TikTok video. Do what the kids say. No mewing over here. Kepsel's free throw, yes. 4-point game. Ryan Spader, he's been in a lot of conversations during these free throws on the sideline.
No, it's Spader. He's probably not even talking about the game.
No, he's something else. So you playing baseball this year, Jordan? 5-point lead for the Tigers.
Got to go if you're DeSmet.
Yeah, don't want to foul your Howard. Rebound. Hinker with the big rebound. And the Howard Tigers, my friend, are your state champions in overtime. Wow. '60-55, and Tiger Nation celebrates in Aberdeen.
Instant classic.
And you, Not only do you win the state title, you knock off the three-time defending state champions who earned every single second of being in this championship game as well.
Yeah, what a great game.
Well played. Unbelievable.
Yeah, well played by both teams. They both squads left everything out there.
And there wasn't a play here, a play there that you look back and say, if we woulda. It's all the plays that were made that you say, yeah, but we remember when we did. You know, those kinds of things all through the night. Unbelievable.
Yeah, so many times. DeSmit gets up one or two, Howard answers. Howard gets up one or two, DeSmit answers. Just
the Bulldogs circle up, have a little conversation. Coach Nick Kepps, I can't wait to visit with him after the awards presentation. We'll catch up with him, get his feelings. I mean, obviously, their jubilation, but just the thought process going through the overtime, the late moments of regulation.
You talked about it too. Howard played, and not just in this game, but all state tournament long, played with poise and
maturity.
Yeah, it's like they're the ones that have been here for 5 years in a row. And I know we mentioned that, and your heart goes out to the DeSmit kids. They left it out there. What a great group. Coach Grunhagen, one of the best in the business.
The double for Howard, Spirit of Six, and the state title. Unbelievable night for Howard. We'll turn it over to Aiden McCafferty.
To present the trophies along with team medals on behalf of the South Dakota High School Activities Association is Joe Out. Assisting with awards and representing the association's corporate partners are Dr. Dalton McDaniel of Sanford Health, Belinda Weller from Dakota Bank, and Specialist Keely Hill from the South Dakota Army National Guard. The runner-up trophy goes to the DeSmit Bulldogs. Tom Anba. Edgar Wilkinson. Gannon Heinrich. Trace Van Regenmorter. Caden Fast. Britt Carlson. Slayton Wilkinson. Noah Luthmers. George Jensen. Tristan Olson. Sam Gigov. Melville Deloy. Carter Wilkinson. Grant Wilkinson. And Tanner Tolzen. Statisticians William Lim, Peyton Botkin, Mark Burkle, managers Brindley Wilkinson, Kaylin Botkin, coaches Clifford Geyer, Becky Geyer, Dustin Olson, and head coach of the DeSmit Bulldogs, Jeff Gruenhagen. Welcome home for DeSmit. We'll be at the Dog Pound Sunday at 3 p.m. Your champions of the 2024 Boys State B Basketball Tournament, the Howard Tigers! Carson Hinker! Will Meyer! Caden Schwatter! Colby Klassen. Colt Becker. Logan Mentelli. Lucas Fieldhaus. Tayden Hoyer. Luke Kapsal. Colt Kapsal. Austin Severson. And Tom Connor. Managers, Harris Terwilliger. Chase Shoemaker. Brody Spader. Cooper Kapsal. Jason Bolden. Statistician Hallie Schultz. Assistant coach Kennedy Kapsal. Ryan Spader. The head coach of the Howard Tigers, Nick Kapsal.
And ladies and gentlemen, there you have your 2024 Class B state champions, the Howard Tigers. We'll have the announcement of our all-tournament team coming up. They are living a dream right now, Steve Erickson.
Yeah, that was fun. Great game. Again, both teams. When you got a state championship, that's what you want.
Turn it over for the all-tournament team announcement.
Keep your attention at center court for the presentation of the all-tournament team. Presenting the awards on behalf of the South Dakota Coaches Association is David Indahl. From Leola Frederick, Braden Sumption. From Viberg Hurley, Nick Hansen. From Gregory Cruz Klunt. From Wessington Springs, Parker Graff. From Castlewood, Brian Lowey. Also from Castlewood, Jameson Kessler. From White River, Nicholas Marshall. Also from White River, Jordan Euler. From DeSmet, Caden Fast. Also from DeSmet, George Jensen. From Howard, Luke Kapsal. Also from Howard, Colt Kapsal.
There you have the all-tournament team and the awards being handed out. We'll take a break, come back, and catch up with the state champion head coach, Nick Kapsal of the Howard Tigers, next on SDPB.
Dreamer, doer, difference maker. These are just a few things we look for when growing our team at Dakota Bank. Those with empathy and a commitment to doing what's right build their careers with us. If you're about relationships and helping others, Dakota Bank is calling. Will you answer? Go with integrity. Go with teamwork. Go with Dakota Bank.
The most gratifying thing about what I do day in and day out is I get to watch things grow.
When you look at corn and the huge role it plays in feed for our cattle and our, you know, our livestock, our pigs is so huge. Also our ethanol plants.
I sit on South Dakota Corn Growers Association. We're focused on policy, so we work with state representatives as well as our state senators and our representative in Washington.
Lucky for us, life is full of choices, big and small, just as it should be. They define us, make us who we are. And when it comes time for you to choose, a car, home, your next big adventure, or start a new business, Farmers Union Insurance has the variety of choices to make sure you have the perfect coverage to protect each perfect moment. Farmers Union Insurance.
Powering the possibilities of tomorrow starts today. For our homes, our farms, our businesses. That's why our Touchstone Energy Cooperative continually plans for the future by utilizing and sourcing safe, reliable power for the next generation. So we can power possibilities long into the future. Touchstone Energy Cooperatives, powering possibilities.
And we're back inside the Barnett Center. Look at the pandemonium going on behind us here. I love it. The Howard Tiger fans and head coach Nick Kepsel. And we were talking off air here just a minute, Nick. Both teams made big plays in this game. It wasn't that a team won it in overtime because of a bad play.
That's the way you want it for a state championship. The refs are letting them play. You get the ball in the guy's hands and you expect them to make plays for you. And it's a lot to ask of them, but our guys absolutely responded in the way I knew they would. To respond in the way after they make that play at the end of regulation, the way that we did in overtime, what more can you ask for out of a group of kids? Unbelievable. I can't describe it.
Go back to the end of regulation. You guys take a timeout with 12 seconds. You draw something up. They foul you. They foul you again. Ball's on the other side. You decide, we better take timeout. Was it the same play, opposite side, or new play?
It was a new play, six less seconds on the clock. I was reluctant to take our last timeout, knowing we had to get the ball in bounds. But I wanted to get the ball in the right guy's hands. I wanted to get it in Luke's hands in a good spot on the floor. And, you know, he made a play. Unfortunately, it didn't get the job done at the time, but ultimately it was a big play for us to finish him off.
We talked at halftime that Luke and Colt had to get touches. He come out the second half. They only have, I think, between them 6 or 8 points in that third quarter, but it was everybody else making big, big shots. Logan had a couple threes. Somebody else had a big bucket. Guys just stepped up tonight.
Yeah, like I knew they would. DeSmet went to zone there in the second half, and I'll be honest, it surprised me. I wasn't expecting that. It took us 3 or 4 possessions to get used to that, and we got guys like Logan Mentley, Colby Clausen. Those guys are capable of knocking down shots, and they showed that they were huge there in the third quarter when we had fell behind, and they hit some big threes and got us right back in the game, and we got control of the game there at that point again.
You add a little title to your name now. It's Nick Kepsel, state champion head coach. Feels good.
Feels great. I'm just happy for everybody else. I'm happy for our school and our town and our kids, most importantly. This is all about those guys, and I'm so happy for them. They deserve everything.
A lot of hometown people, and that's got to be extra special to come your own school. I mean, you grew up there, you played, and now look at all these people celebrating.
Yeah, this is for all of Minor County. We got Carthage, Canova, Fedora, Winford, Howard. This is for the whole county. Just so happy for everybody involved.
Appreciate the time. Congratulations. Go enjoy it.
Thank you.
You bet. Head coach Nick Kepsel. And, hey, we're going to throw up for some stats, talk a little bit about stats and highlights, and then we'll get moving on.
Yeah, wow, what a game. You know, an overtime state championship game, that's what you want. Brad was calling for it with about 5 minutes left in the game, wanting to call an overtime game, and they delivered. But both teams competed like champions, and ultimately one's got to win, and Howard pulled that out. But shot 55, 56% for the game. DeSmit was at a 38% clip. Howard 17 and 19 from the line, and some big ones down the stretch, and especially in overtime. But Coach Brad just got done talking to Coach Kepsel, and big plays by a lot of guys. Clausen and Mentley knocking down threes. And then DeSmit comes back down here. Britt Carlson hits a big three to give him a lead in overtime. Trace Van Regenmoor, his defense all night. Rebounds, he knocks down a couple threes. George Jensen, Caden Fast. I mean, what a game. What a you talk about a state championship.
Yeah.
That's what you want.
Yeah,
that was.
You can't ask for anything better. I just said to Joelle, gave her a hug, thanked her, and said, oh, what a way for you to end your career here at state tournament-wise on a game like that. She's like, you couldn't ask for anything better. So, hey, we'll take a break. We'll come back, get our thoughts on just the whole weekend, and then we'll wrap things up from Aberdeen. You're watching the Class B State Boys Basketball Tournament on SDPB.
Sometimes having 15 of something is great, like 15 pizzas. Yo! Nice. But for days of class missed, 15 or more is not so great. The best way for students to own their tomorrow is being present today. See why good habits matter at showupsd.com.
Our teams are committed to improving quality of life in our communities. Whether we're planning construction concepts, building a new downtown development, bringing new businesses to our communities, or maintaining your apartment home. We believe everyone deserves a well-built and well-managed place to live and work. This is Lloyd.
Oh my goodness.
You're committed to building relationships, to exceeding expectations, to serving your community. Your financial partner should share your vision and your values. For 130 years, we've stood by South Dakotans. We've been there, we'll be there. Convenient, connected, committed. Bank West, member FDIC.
I decided to switch my major. I didn't want to do sports anymore, so I decided Southeast Tech would be a good one for me to go. The current instructor is a captain with the Highway Patrol. He had a lot of experience and knowledge about the job. I serve the people just as much as they serve me.
Back inside the Barnett Center in Aberdeen, I'm Brad DeBeer alongside Steve Erickson. And wow, you know, we talked about the games, but the tournament as a whole, the atmosphere, you know, we've touched on it throughout the weekend. Just an unbelievable experience to come here and be a part of it and then have the games that we had.
Yeah, I've played in it. I've coached in it. I've been here as a fan doing this front row with those types of games and being around the game and knowing the coaches and getting to visit with the officials and just all of that. So much fun.
Yeah.
Appreciate it. Thank you guys for it. But, yeah, it's a tremendous tournament. We said it from the get-go. Any of those eight teams could do it. You play it eight more times, and you might have seven more different winners. So, great tournament, and that's all you can ask for. Great Class B tournament in a great venue.
And, again, all those great games, but just the most unbelievable way to finish it as well with huge plays down the stretch. 1.5 seconds left in the game, and some teams quit. DeSmit didn't. Howard didn't after that. Ryan Spader said to me after the game, the team that usually makes that last second shot to go into overtime usually wins, and his kids didn't. So happy with that. Here's a recap. You see the schedule flashing up there.
That game earlier, Castlewood got away from White River, played so well. And then the finish, 55-50, the final in overtime, Howard over DeSmit. What a state tournament, what a finish, what a championship game. Again, a big thanks to our camera guys, Kingsley, Brandon, Talon, Jeremiah. You guys were awesome. We appreciate everything you did. In the back, Levi and Brian, of course, along with Christian, and all the work you guys did. Aiden was there, I know, earlier too. So thanks to everybody for all your help. Thanks to Steve for joining us. We appreciate the help.
Yeah, thank you guys for asking me. I appreciate it.
That was a lot of fun. I'm Brad DeBeer for Steve Erickson from Aberdeen. The 2024 winter sports season is come to a close. We'll talk to you again soon on SDPB. Have a great weekend, everybody.